So Ron Rivera is a little busy these days, but not busy enough to forget where he came from. A linebacker at Cal, and check out the sweater he has donned to root those Golden Bears on this afternoon.
And you were saying, and I thought it was pretty mean, but you were saying, I thought ugly sweater season was over. And I said, wow, that's a nice guy wearing a nice sweater. Yeah. Lockheed Martin Armed
Forces Bowl. Represent your alma mater.
Is next, Cal and Air Force.
Good afternoon and welcome to Fort Worth, where 10 minutes ago, four F-35s from Luke Air Force Base entered our Bull Stadium airspace, roughly 15 miles to our west. We welcome in the pilot, Major Josh Arkey from the 61st Fighter Squadron, up in the cockpit. Major Arkey, how's everything looking?
Howdy, Dave. Things look great from here. It's a perfect day for football. I can see the stadium on the horizon and the flyovers to go.
In that case, I'll let you take it from here. What a way to start. Welcome to the Lockheed Martin Armed Forces Bowl as a part of Capital One Bowl Mania from chilly Fort Worth, Texas. Our matchup out of the Mountain West, the Falcons of the Air Force Academy. From the Pac-12, the Golden Bears of the University of California and their star quarterback, Jared Goff. So Jared Goff and company in what will almost certainly be his final game at Cal. It's been a record-setting career, 4,000-plus yards, 37 touchdowns this year, and we mentioned the contrast in styles. Troy Calhoun's Air Force Academy, they will run the ball with the triple option. That is what they do. For more on that, well, we'll wait till after kickoff because we are ready to go here from Fort Worth, Texas. The Cal Bears won the toss. They have deferred, so we're going to see that triple option right away. They run the ball about as much as anybody in the country. Cal throws it about as much as anybody. Both offenses very productive. You expect to see a lot of points here on what has turned into a chilly but nice day in Fort Worth. And our Lockheed Martin Armed Forces Bowl is underway. A short kickoff and returnable for Air Force. In fact, a nice return outside the 30 to the 32-yard line. And now we will welcome in Allison Williams.
Hey there, Dave. Air Force runs that triple option, an offense often used to be an equalizer against opponents that are faster and stronger. Well, Air Force offensive coordinator Mike Thiessen said that Cal is bigger and stronger than anyone they have faced this year. So it's not enough to just run the offense. They have to execute it at a very high level. That means paying attention to all the details, coming off the ball hard, leaning forward earlier. Everything they do must be executed with as much physicality and speed as possible to have success against this Cal defense.
All right, good stuff, Allison. And Carson Roberts, the senior from the state of Texas, is the quarterback, and he has been since the early parts of this year, and he's really grown into the starting quarterback role. And we will see an immediate dive play straight up the middle for a nice gain for Air Force.
Surprise, surprise, the dive play. Jacoby Owens carrying the ball, and he is the guy that we believe is going to be the impact player. They're going to run the dive. The option is based on that. On the other side of the ball, Hardy Nickerson is the guy, inside linebacker, over 100 tackles this year, has to stop the dive.
So our impact players brought to you by the U.S. Navy. And now the pitch play on the option, very close. I think stopped just a little bit short of the first down. That was Garrett Brown. And they will use their receivers as pitch backs, essentially. It's a little different variation that Air Force runs of the triple option.
It is, and those receivers are actually running backs that can block down the field when they don't carry the ball, but they want to stretch the Cal defense. They want to make them play inside out. They're going to get the ball on the perimeter, but their speed, it's more like Air Force should run the ball right up the middle and take advantage of that with the dive.
Well, and in fact, with that spot, they did get the first down. So it's first and 10 Air Force. A big part, Mike, of the strategy of this game for Air Force is we saw Goff. We know how good he is. Cal can put up points. Basically, play keep away.
Play keep away. Time of possession. They talked about needing to average at least 4 yards per carry to keep the ball away from that potent Cal offense.
So the first down of the game for Air Force. 8-win team, 8-5, 6-2 in the Mountain West, played for the Mountain West Championship. Pitch to Timothy McVeigh, who has done a nice job later in the year for Air Force. But there was no room that time.
No, and I like McVeigh. He's made a real impact his last couple games of the season. He's been the guy, the go-to guy on the outside. But that's not the strength of this Air Force offense against the Cal defense. Cal is probably one of the better athletic groups Air Force is going to play this year.
So second and 10 for Air Force with the ball first here from Fort Worth. Roberts under center. Fakes the dive and another pitch. McVeigh a little more running room this time to the 45-yard line. Time to take a look at our keys to the game brought to you by Lockheed Martin.
And the keys to the game for Cal are basically stop the dive. We said that earlier. Play clean, which means catch the ball and limit turnovers. Flipping it for Air Force, they have to sustain drives with controlled tempo. They've got to take time off the clock. They have to make sure they don't allow any big explosion plays that Cal offense, and they got to get pressure on Jared Goff, get him off his mark.
Well, for Air Force, this counts as a third and long, third and six, and that's not what this offense is totally equipped to do from the shotgun. And Roberts is going to keep it and get the first down and much more into Cal territory, all the way down to the 40-yard line, first down Air Force.
And one of the things you're going to find, no matter what the formation, no matter what the down and distance, there is no obvious pass situation. Air Force can run it at any time, at quarterback run, option. They will throw the ball, but they're very efficient in trying to throw that football.
So that was 14 yards and a third down conversion for the Falcons. On the move to start the game. And as soon as they get that first down, they do slow the tempo up.
Yeah, they vary the tempo. They'll go fast sometimes when they feel they've got somebody on their heels, but they can also slow it down.
A dive to Owens with a spin move to get a couple of yards, and they'll spot him forward for a gain of three.
Nice job by Jacoby Owens that time being patient. Sometimes that dive is right over the center. Sometimes it moves out one hole. It's going to depend a lot on how the line blocking is, but they're going to change it. One of the things from a defensive standpoint, you've got to stop the dive, and you've got to vary who takes the quarterback and who takes the pitch on the edge.
And he is an interesting player. You see the numbers, over 1,000 yards for a second straight year. He has been more of a tailback in the past because of all the injuries at the fullback position. You're used to seeing a bigger player at that spot of the triple option. He's just about 200 pounds, and yet he's been very effective. The pitch play, that's Garrett Brown. Brown, a big gain to the 20, to the 15.
One of the issues when you play an option team like Air Force is finding out how fast they're going to run it at the beginning of the game. The first couple series are a heck of a matchup issue because you got to decide how quickly it happens and make sure that you see the cut block down the field there, because that's what they do. They're going to take and not chop block, but cut block, block below the knees. That allows a smaller team like Air Force to compete against bigger opponents.
That was 23 yards on that one. It's not quite first and goal. They'll spot the ball at about the 13-yard line, but seven rushes, no passes yet for Air Force on this game-opening drive. Dive to Owens inside the 10, down to the 9-yard line.
The dive is the steady diet that keeps a defense honest and also holds them on the inside, which allows you to get a half a man to the attack on the outside with the option. So remember, that dive is going to be a staple all game long.
Well, you mentioned the early possessions. I mean, Cal spent a lot of time to get the bowl preparation, the extra practices to prepare for the triple option. None of these players essentially have ever played against a triple option team in a real game, so it's a lot different. Roberts will pitch it this time and to the edge, but not a lot of room. That was pursued well.
And to your point, Dave, if you haven't seen it, you never know how fast it's going to happen, and you can't simulate that speed in practice. And that's the most difficult thing. That's why this first series is a wake-up for a Cal team, because now they see how fast it's going to happen, how quickly they have to get off blocks to make sure that they can stay in their gap, find out who has the ball. Cal talked about the fact that sometimes they practice with no footballs, sometimes they practice against guys with three footballs, because you have to do your assignment. It's discipline, keep the eyes right.
Well, it's not third and goal, it's third and three. Another pitch play, not a great pitch, and that is going to go backwards. And that may well impact the decision here. Now, there is a penalty flag down on the play, and that might have been, there's a chance that this could be a targeting type call. But I thought that Nathan Broussard, let's see.
Personal foul, face mask, defense. Number 21.
Targeting, but there was definitely contact up around the helmet. And that is a face mask. What a huge penalty against Cal. It will be first and goal Air Force.
Huge penalty. And what you notice, too, that through that off is Coach Calhoun talked about the pass and hoping to mimic the kind of things, because they run so many different options, and there are paths that each of the running backs or receivers have to take. And if they don't practice a lot on it, he was worried about that. There the pitch was a little high, but the penalty resulted in obviously a great opportunity now for Air Force down on the 2.5-3 yard line.
So instead of the negative play, which I think would have forced a field goal attempt for Air Force, it's first and goal, and for the Falcons, it may well be four chances to get 2 yards.
And points are going to be a premium for Air Force, because they know that Cal is probably going to score. They've got to try to match him or get ahead on the touchdown ratio.
The tight end Griffin goes in motion. Roberts will hand the ball off. And close to the goal line, but not quite there. Timothy McVay stopped maybe a half a yard short.
And interesting, we talk about the multiplicity of what Air Force does. There they line up in a power eye attack. And so they can run the option, they can run traditional power plays. And rarely do they do it, though, against somebody who they feel is as big or stronger than they are. So I'm surprised they've gone away from the option at this point. But with the ball at the 6-inch line, you could see anything here.
Now this is the part of the field where you tend to see a little bit more of that from Air Force. We've got Owens essentially as a lone fullback. And they'll give it to Owens left side, and he finds his way in. Touchdown, Air Force. Well, what a start for the Falcons, exactly the way they would have drawn it up. A long drive, keep it on the ground, and punch it in for 6.
No question. Take time off the clock, get a touchdown. That is Troy Calhoun's plan for the day.
So the perfect start for Air Force with an extra point coming. Strable, the place kicker. 11 plays, 68 yards, 6 minutes and 27 seconds off the clock. The extra point is up and good.
Well, you can see this is just a slight slant off the outside. They're going to try to get in that end zone with power. Nice job of reading it by Jacoby. Get the touchdown to go ahead.
You saw our flyover coverage from the opening of our telecast. The paratroopers also came in pregame, part of this great Lockheed Martin Armed Forces Bowl, where a big part of it is not just celebrating the football players on the field, but our armed forces around this country and all over the world. And how fitting that the Air Force Academy is part of this game. They've been here many times before. They love being here at Fort Worth. And they must love the start they've had. Air Force off to a 7-0 lead against Cal from the Pac-12 after a nice long opening game drive. Now a shorter kickoff will be returnable for Trevor Davis to the 25 with room to the 30, and gets out to the 35, where Jared Goff and the Cal offense will take the field for the first time.
And Jared Goff, only a junior, but one of the best pure passers in the nation. We talked about being a probable first-round draft choice if it goes out, and a much better leader this year for his team. He does it all. He's got every type of throw, but he's got an uncanny awareness in the pocket, and he's a better scrambler when necessary than you would think.
So in a way, I think it's a bittersweet day for Cal fans, because it could well, almost certainly is, the last time they will see Jared Goff, who has been such a big part of this program's revival. Almost certainly his last game at Cal, and hoping to lead the Bears to a bowl win, their first bowl since 2011. And Goff throwing on first down. Nice catch by one of his many talented targets. That's Maurice Harris.
He's got a ton of targets. The 5 senior wide. I think they put that in the paper, so Air Force at least knew what the first play was going to be. Didn't help, though.
Tony Franklin, the offensive coordinator. They've got a very talented receiving corps and a lot of experience. 5 seniors all on the field at the same time. And now on second down, they will hand the ball off to Trey Watson with a big gain across midfield. Watson all the way down to the 30 and inside the 30. He'll be spotted at the Air Force 29. So it's not all about the pass game. Cal can run the ball a little bit too.
They're very simplistic in their approach. This outside zone play is one of the staples of what they do. Great job by the offensive line, reach blocking, and getting the running back untouched to the outside. The speed factor is going to scare Air Force today.
That's 33 yards on the ground for Watson, who has really emerged late in the year for Cal. They play fake to Watson right over the middle, and maybe a little too much on that pass, although Bryce Treggs had a chance. Now here comes a flag. Weston Steelhammer, who is one of Air Force's most important players, and I think Air Force could be a little nervous as to what this penalty is.
And he's also one of the biggest hitters. He's right on the edge sometimes. And when that receiver is defenseless as he was, it's going to be either a unnecessary roughness
personal
penalty
foul,
or something.
Targeting on the defense,
and
number
is
eight.
A targeting call. Now,
the
Troy
previous
Calhoun's
play
not happy.
Is under
Matt
further
Loeffler,
review.
Part of this SEC officiating crew makes the call. All targeting calls are reviewed. So they will take a look upstairs, but this is obviously huge for Air Force.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't see any helmet-to-helmet contact. It looked like it was a strike with the left shoulder. Let's take a look. Well, their heads, the helmets do bump, and based on what I've seen sometimes in these bowl games, remember, when in question, it is a foul, if there is a question about it. So I'm not sure how I can call this one. Could go either way.
Yeah, I mean, watching that, I'm thinking the call is going to be upheld. And yeah, if it is, Weston Steelhammer is maybe their most important player on defense. He's the leader in the secondary, first-team all-conference, and it didn't take him long to review.
After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Number
and
eight
it
is
confirmed, and that
from
means Weston Steelhammer, just a handful of plays
first
into
down.
This game, will be done for the rest of the day. Wow, that is huge for Air Force.
Yeah, that deals a severe blow to Air Force in terms of what they probably want to do today, because part of pressuring Jared Goff is going to be putting the safeties in either man-to-man or really zone situations where they've got to read, and he's their most experienced and their biggest playmaker in that secondary.
So the penalty yardage, that's one thing, and it moves Cal closer inside the 15, but far bigger for Air Force. And you can see Troy Calhoun, he can argue as much as he wants. He's not going to win the argument. They reviewed it, and they confirmed the call on the field of targeting.
And there's no question. The officials now are trying to change the game of football to protect the players, and it takes time. You're just not going to get away with that anymore.
It's hard to overstate how critical that is. Already, Air Force fans are not happy about it. Already up against this prolific pass attack, and the quarterback Goff, all the receivers he has, and now without their best safety and best playmaker in the secondary for basically the whole game. Pressure comes, Goff lobs one to the end zone, and it's incomplete. Well, Darius Powell was there, and for a moment it looked to me like he almost slowed up a little bit.
I think he lost the ball. I think actually he was starting to turn, and the ball was thrown with great trajectory. Nice job by Goff, because they brought pressure, unblocked man right in his face. He tossed it up there, and I think had he continued to run and just stride through that, he'd be able to get it. But
well, the coverage,
I'll get another shot.
The coverage, Mike, was from Tyler Weaver, who has essentially replaced Weston Steelhammer, just ejected from the game because of the targeting penalty. And the coverage wasn't great. Now an open receiver. It's Powell, makes the catch right around the five, very close to a first down.
One thing about this Cal offense, you're always going to see the play fake one way or the other, and they can run it, he can throw it, and he's in tremendous simpatico with his receivers in terms of the timing of it.
Well, they're going to stop the clock. And our referee's going to take a look, and it looks like he's going to ask for a measurement. So close enough to measure. It's the second time in this first quarter where the sticks on the opposite side of the field haven't totally matched where the chains have been. So there's been a little confusion about where the spot is and whether it's a first down or not. So they will measure here. I don't think they're going to tackle the
one other thing about this Cal football team this year on offense, at least, they've got a variety of receivers. They also have a variety of running backs that have contributed over the course of the season. Daniel Askew was the returning guy from last year. He's been hurt most of the year. Trey Watson's done a great job. Enwery, Muhammad, I mean, I've seen all of those guys jump out at me on film the last three games of the season.
That's about as close as it can get without being a first down. So they're short. It's third and inches for the Bears, trying to tie this game on their opening drive of this Armed Forces Bowl from Fort Worth, Texas. Sonny Dykes, his third year at Cal. It's been a tumultuous few weeks for Coach Dykes with interviews for other jobs.
Interest, yes, from other places.
Interest from other programs, but an agreement on a contract extension. So I think Cal fans are happy about that.
Normally, for most teams, this would be a pretty much 100% rundown, but with Cal, you never know. They are very confident in Jared Goff's ability to get him in the right play, do whatever's necessary.
Watson, the tailback, in an I formation on third and inches. They give it to the fullback, and they'll get the first down. It'll be first and goal. And the fullback is essentially one of their other tailbacks, Vic Enwery, who, as you mentioned, he has played well.
Yeah, and at 6'1", 230 pounds, he could be a fullback in some people's offense.
They have another fullback who's going to come in the game here, number 99, who's about 100 pounds heavier.
Fullback is a great description of his body size.
Yeah, he fills up.
He might be 2.5 backs.
Malik McMorris, the true freshman walk-on, is really a cool story for Cal. Goff is going to hand the ball off. And Wary to the goal line and stops short. Air Force fans were happy with the effort to drive in Wary backwards, but the forward progress gets him inside the one. Brody Hicks led the way with the tackle.
It's tough. That defensive line for Air Force, their defensive front, is giving up 20 to 30 to 40 pounds per man to the offensive line. This is a power struggle down here.
Second and goal from inside the one. Goff again hands it off, and Wary, end zone touchdown. Well, a nice answer for the Bears after Air Force scores on its first drive. Cal answers, an extra point away from tying the game.
And we talked about Sonny Dykes knew that he has to match scores, because with Air Force, if they score, they take a lot of time off the clock, and you're going to get fewer opportunities today. So he's got to take advantage of every possession. Great job by the offensive line. Huge hole on the right side. You and I probably could have scored on that play.
Maybe. 7 plays, 65 yards, mostly on the ground for Cal. Matt Anderson, the sophomore place kicker, with the extra point up and good. We expect offense. We've had some offense. And a handoff and Wary for the first touchdown of the game for the Bears. It's 7-7.
The 2015 Lockheed Martin Armed Forces Bowl, brought to you by Lockheed Martin. We never forget who we're working for. Quicksilver from Capital One. Earn unlimited 1.5% cash back every purchase, every day. And Rain-X wiper blades. Rain-X, outsmart the elements.
Both coaches, Sonny Dykes, Troy Calhoun, got a chance to get in that F-35 simulator during their trip here to Texas over at the Lockheed Martin Aeronautics plant here in Fort Worth. Coach Calhoun, who is himself an Air Force graduate, not sure that was the cleanest approach for Coach Calhoun, but anyway, just a simulator.
He's just a little bit out of practice on that.
Yeah, it's been a while. 7-7, and Air Force with the kick return. Nice return for Tyler Williams outside the 30. That's where Air Force will start. Well, if it's on ESPN, it's on E. That ESPN app now streams just like the Watch ESPN has. We've taken two things you love and made it one right there on that ESPN app. And speaking of, the latest Dish, brought to you by Dish. All kinds of games. Bowl mania in full effect now. And not just today with North Carolina Baylor to follow us, then LSU Texas Tech later tonight. Tomorrow you got Auburn, Memphis, NC State, Mississippi State, and more good games to come. So fire up that app.
I need to get ready. I got to have that thing with me at all times, I'll tell you what.
No matter where you are, Air Force with the ball for the second time. Both teams scoring touchdowns on their first drives. And a keeper for the quarterback, Carson Roberts. a gain of one.
That first possession, actually, Air Force surprised me. They only ran three dives out of 15 plays, but they pitched the ball outside five of those times and had great success getting to the outside against a Cal defense that runs pretty well. So it'll be interesting to see. Cal now should have a sense of how fast it's going to happen. You would hope to see some improvement from the defense in this drive.
Second and nine. With Owens at fullback behind Roberts, they fake it to him, and they're going to throw the ball for the first time in the game, taking a deep shot, and a jump ball, really incomplete, knocked away. Intended for Jalen Robinette. Let's send it down to Allison Williams.
Dave, to Mike's point, Cal defensive coordinator Kaufman told us that the option will be a foreign language to our kids, and he was interested to see how they do the first couple series, how they adjust to the speed of the game, learning what they need to do based on what Air Force does. I will tell you, when this Cal defense came to the sideline, there was a lot of conversation, players talking amongst themselves about what they are seeing, coaches reminding them of their keys based on formation, what to do if Air Force overloads. So a lot of adjustments already taking place early in this game.
And now a third and nine, trying to force an Air Force punt. Roberts in the pocket with a lot of time. Now on the move, he will throw the ball away. So good adjustments from Cal as they'll force the three and out.
Yeah, not the strength of Air Force, third and nine, trying to throw the football in a standard drop back mode. That is what Cal defense wants to force. The other thing is, Jalen Robinette is their big play guy. He's been shut out for two straight games. And the one pass play we saw earlier was really, he was not open, but they trust him to go up and get the ball. He's one of the best athletes on that team.
So Strable, who is the place kicker and also the punter for Air Force. With Trevor Davis back to return. Fair catch signal. He makes it at around the 34-yard line. So Jared Goff and the Cal offense back on the field when we come back. Well, great scene outside the home of TCU. We're here in Fort Worth on the campus of TCU for this Armed Forces Bowl. 7-7 the score, first quarter, 4:39 to go. Dave Fleming, Mike Bellotti, Allison Williams with you. The Air Force band in full effect as the Cal offense is out on the field for the second time. Both teams scoring touchdowns on their first drives, but Air Force's second drive was a three and out. So now Cal has the ball back with Jared Goff on the field.
And he hasn't had to do much. They've been able to run the ball very efficiently in that first drive.
Only one wide receiver on this formation. That's pretty unusual for Cal. They will hand it off straight ahead with Watson, who is stopped after a gain of a couple of yards. And our impact player is brought to you by the U.S. Navy when Cal's got the ball.
Well, it's Kenny Lawler, the receiver with great range, over 10 touchdowns this year. And on the flip side, Alex Hansen, the energy provider for that Air Force defense, has to make sure he gets Jared Goff off the mark so he can't throw the ball to Kenny Lawler.
But part of what Air Force does on defense, they do bring a lot of pressure. They are a very aggressive defense. And Hansen's a big part of that. They'll rush just three here on second down. Goff over the middle. Perfect delivery for a first down into Air Force territory.
The Air Force defense has talked all year that they've got a change point. They have to vary the pressure. Here you see only a three-man rush, which means they got maximum drop. But Goff is such a great quarterback and has great touch. He put the ball right over underneath defender.
Quickly to the line of scrimmage and the handoff to Watson, who gets back to the line of scrimmage, but no more.
As we watch this game unfold, Cal literally has two running plays, outside zone either way, and a slight trap play inside. And that's it. They run two plays, so their offensive line doesn't have to think about too much because they spend a lot of time adjusting pass protections.
Cal's offensive line has not been a strength. I think in the last few weeks, they felt like they got better play up front. But to me, it makes Goff's performance even more remarkable, even in this up-tempo, air-it-out offense. Without a great line, he had Powell open and overthrew his intended target, incomplete.
And that's twice he's overthrown Powell. I don't think Powell is the fastest receiver. He's a great possession guy, physical, one of the bigger guys at almost 220 pounds. So that's the one time that Jared Goff's touch has escaped him a little bit.
Mike, we've talked about how third and long for the Air Force offense, not good for their defense. They love these kind of situations where they can bring their pressures.
They can dial up some pressure. They're going to line three or four or five guys up there. You don't know which guys are coming, which guys are dropping. That's the challenge to the offensive line and to Jared Goff.
Five receivers, Goff all alone in the backfield on third and 10. Here comes some pressure. Goff gets rid of it and completes it. And then the run after the catch for the first down, all the way down to the 10-yard line from the second tight end, Raymond Hudson. What a big play by him. It's first and goal, Cal, 29 yards.
Great job by Jared Goff staying in the pocket. You're going to see a free rusher come off the right side of the screen. He puts the ball right on the money to the receiver down the field. Live by the sword, die by the sword. That's the problem with the blitz.
And Goff is very good against pressure. Perfect pass there. Handoff, right side running, trying to get to that corner and to the corner. Nice run for Khalfani Muhammad, who has been banged up late in the year. He is an explosive player.
I think he's probably the fastest running back that Cal has. He is tremendously explosive, as you say. He got the edge that time and also broke a tackle. Now Cal knocking on the door down inside the five.
Only 79 rushing attempts on the year for Muhammad, but better than 500 yards, almost 7 yards a carry. Second and goal for the Bears inside the five. Goff looking to throw toward the corner. Perfect pass and dropped right in the hands of Bryce Treggs. That should have been a touchdown.
No question about it. He'd like to have that one again. And Treggs is one of the most athletic of those receivers. He has some drops occasionally. This is just a question of concentration, watching it all the way in. Not contested and a perfect throw.
That was as routine of a catch as you can have. So for a guy who's been a very productive player and a senior playing in his last game in a Cal uniform, a missed chance for Treggs. Now it's third and goal.
This is survey says the coaches are calling this play from the sideline based on what they see.
Sonny Dykes is running toward the official. He wants a timeout, and he will get that timeout. So Cal didn't
before
have exactly
the snap,
what they wanted.
Timeout, California. That's their first of the half.
That's the longest Sonny's run in a while.
I just going to say, I think getting him some oxygen there on the sidelines. I mean, they had a chance to call that play and didn't like it, obviously, or decided to change it. We're in the wrong group, whatever the case may be.
So timeout, Bears. Capital One Bowl Mania rolls on tonight. We've got the Russell Athletic Bowl. Top 20 matchup, North Carolina and Baylor. Do Baylor have any more players left for that game? That one's at 5:30 Eastern, and then the Advocare V100 Texas Bowl, LSU Texas Tech at 9 Eastern down in Houston tonight on ESPN. Well, I mean, for Baylor, the offense has been so productive, but they're so banged up.
Who's going to play quarterback? I mean, that's the question. And then LSU Texas Tech, that's another contrast in styles. Leonard Fournette, I wonder if Les Miles is going to unveil his new offense and help him keep his job in this game. I don't know.
Well, Leonard Fournette, the most productive running back in terms of yards per game in the country. Texas Tech, look, they throw the ball. They've got great offense. They don't play a lot of run defense.
Not a lot of defense. No, it's not a match made in heaven.
I have a feeling Leonard Fournette is going to have a very big game. Third and goal out of the timeout for Goff and Cal. And where he is the back along his right side. Goff is going to keep it and try to get there himself. I would say, Mike, that is not the strength of his game now. He lost the ball. Air Force has it, and they haven't blown the play dead. And it's a foot race, and it will be at midfield if the play stands. That was Grant Ross, a linebacker who scooped and tried to score. What a turn here, and Goff is looking up at the video board inside the stadium wondering if he was down.
That's a design quarterback run, quarterback power. You can see here the back and the off guard. Rigsby come through. The ball right there is not stopped. Let's see if it actually where it comes out. They haven't ruled his progression dead, and really I don't see it there, and it's hard to tell from that angle if and when it could have been down. No whistle, though, and you have to have what's the word for video evidence?
Indisputable.
No disputes. I want to make sure. And he took a pop right there, too. He was held up, and a guy took a shot at him. And that's
the previous play is under further review.
Well, two things here. Number one, I think he was down. Just looking at that. Again, you're right. You got to have the indisputable evidence. Does the elbow hit there? Does he still have the ball?
That's what you can't tell. Where is the ball when that left elbow hits down? Because that looks as if that's the first part of his body that would make him down.
Number two, my second point, and we're going to keep looking at this to see if we can tell definitively.
Is his progress stopped? I would have thought that was one of the cases, too.
Why on earth would Cal call that play?
Well, down in the red zone, especially there, typically because people are going to blitz, you want to have the added back. Now, I would do it out of a wildcat as opposed to having my All-American first draft choice quarterback be the guy carrying the ball. But it is a very common play now in the red zone, especially inside the five for power teams.
The second part of this also could be, now what if they rule that the ball is coming out, but that Grant Ross, when he recovered the fumble, himself was
down.
I mean, he's sitting on the ground there, and he's the guy who gets up and starts running.
Yeah, it's...
So even if they...
Right.
Even from there...
Where's the ball at that point? Because obviously he's on the ground.
Yeah, maybe the ball is coming out there.
Oh, yeah, it's out. It's out. It was on top of his body. Yeah, you're right, but he's down. The guy who recovered the ball is down right there when he picks it up off the ground and is on his knees. So that, I think, at this point, I'd say it's probably going to be a turnover, but I think it's going to be way back. They're going to lose that 50-yard return.
You got all these weapons. You got a quarterback who slings it around, a perfect pass that was dropped for a touchdown a couple plays prior, and you run the quarterback draw.
Well,
on the goal to go play, and whatever you think about the play call, this is obviously a huge ruling here.
Yeah, and they've been having success running the football. That's how they scored last time. But you're right, that was a changeup. Sometimes you, for bowl practices, coaches can outsmart themselves. They got too much time to think about, hey, new plays and new ideas.
This is not an easy one for our replay official, Doyle Jackson, part of the SEC crew.
And one of the things right now, it is the ruling on
after review,
and the run is
the quarterback's coming. Elbow was down before the ball came out.
So
therefore,
the elbow
it'll be
down.
Fourth down
huge,
at the 5-yard line.
Huge turn of events in terms
five.
Of momentum in this
game. Clock
now it's Cal's ball still
reset
down
the game clock
inside
to 229.
The 2-3-yard line.
2:29 on the game clock, please.
I guess that's the moment of truth right there. The elbow down, and then the ball starts to come loose. And Cal has a decision to make. It's fourth and goal, but you can see Goff has his helmet off. He's on the sideline. Sonny Dykes has already decided he's going to kick the field goal.
Take the points. I think at this point in time, Air Force is a good team, not a great team in terms of scoring offensively. So you want to take advantage of getting points anytime you're down there.
Matt Anderson, who's been hot, has made 10 field goals in a row, and they're going to try to fake, and it's a bad snap. Ball's on the ground. Anderson takes a big hit, and Air Force has it. My goodness. Those last two plays are not going to go in the Cal Hall of Fame.
They will not be Hall of Fame plays for sure. And certainly, you don't mind taking a risk if you came back from a thing that could have sucked the momentum out of you by getting the ball back. And then trying to figure out where this was going to go, if this was just going to be a kicker run. The right tight end there was trying to release, whether he was blocking or going out for a pass. You see him right there, but the reality is it's not good execution.
I think it was a pretty good snap. The place kicker, Matt Anderson, just dropped it, and Troy Calhoun pumped with the way that sequence went. So Cal had first and goal. They come away with nothing. And now Owens for Air Force, that dive play stopped for no gain.
Now the onus is on the Cal defense right now to sort of grab back the momentum. They had stopped Air Force on the last drive. The offense had marched down to the 3-yard line, turned the ball over on downs or whatever you want to call it. And conversely now, Air Force got to be fired up to take advantage of this opportunity.
First drive, 6.5 minutes essentially. Second drive with a couple incompletions was a 3-and-out.
That's why they don't throw the ball a lot. You get that incompletion, that takes you behind the chains or out of your rhythm on the sticks.
Now pitch play on 2nd and 9. And Garrett Brown, who's got pretty good speed to the edge, gets knocked out of bounds to set up 3rd down. And we're getting the bowl game started here today from Fort Worth. After us, North Carolina Baylor, 5:30 Eastern. the Russell Athletic Bowl. ACC, Big 12, we're in Big 12 country here at Fort Worth. We're on the campus of a Big 12 school that we play in a few days from now in the Alamo Bowl, TCU and Oregon. It promises to be a heck of a game. The keeper on third down and well defended by California. So the Bears have settled in against the triple option. Raymond Davidson, who actually got the start. Davidson in place of Jalen Jefferson, who is out, a normal starter with injury, and he's made a couple nice plays.
Seemed like they've done their homework against the option. They're doing a great job of canceling the dive, taking care of the keep, and then covering the pitch, especially in those situations where there could be a potential play fake to throw the ball down the field.
Cal will often use those two punt returners, in this case, Harris and Davis. Strable will punt it for the second time. That one could be returnable. No fair catch signal by Harris. Kind of a risky play, but a good play. Across midfield, the Bears are going to start in Air Force territory. So good field position for California. Dave Fleming, Mike Bellotti, happy to have you with us here from Fort Worth. And we're thinking about a lot of folks in this area, Mike, who were impacted by some horrific weather the last few days. It's been crazy here in this area. We're happy to report that things are a little calmer here in Fort Worth, just a few miles away, close to the Cotton Bowl, where a couple days from now at semifinal game, Alabama-Michigan State college football is huge in this part of the world right now as Cal with the ball. Treggs hangs on to this one. Nice pass from Goff down to the 30.
Well, Goff getting limbered up. He took quite a shot last time when he tried to run the football in on a power running play. I think stick to what he does best. Let him throw the football.
I agree. Final few seconds of the first quarter. Goff in the shotgun. Will throw. And taking a shot toward the end zone. Treggs, touchdown. What a pass from Jared Goff. And his senior teammate hangs on this time. 30 yards. It's 13-7.
That was pretty quick, and that's a mismatch. The speed of the Cal receivers in space against the secondary of Air Force. If you can't pressure Goff, you've got to change up the looks back there. But also, it's nice to give Trey another chance to redeem himself. Dropped a touchdown pass earlier, makes a very nice catch on that from a great throw.
Man, you want to know why Jared Goff could be a top five draft pick in the NFL in a couple of months? To me, that throw is a reason why.
Well, yes, his touch, and that's what we've talked about a lot, is he can throw every type of pass.
That was spectacular. So after the good field position, Cal, a couple plays, takes advantage big time.
Watch over here. We're going to get a deep pass right there. And one of the things is it's one-on-one situation. It doesn't really matter. Here he gets the move there and does this deep corner route. And the more you have a guy beat, the deeper you set your angle as a wide receiver. And this one perfectly thrown over the top. Nice catch right in the breadbasket.
It was Tyler Weaver who, again, part of the story of this game is Weston Steelhammer, their all-conference starting safety, was ejected for the game because of a targeting penalty. That was Weaver on Treggs there with the it wasn't horrible coverage.
No, but you think the coaches are saying, hey, we're going at the backup guy? Yeah. You find a guy, if there's a substitute or an injury in that secondary, you're going to test him very quickly.
So Goff and Cal found him, and Bryce Treggs makes up for the drop in the end zone from a few moments earlier with a very nice catch, but that was number 16 at his best. Final 2 seconds of the first quarter. We did figure we'd see some big plays. Air Force almost dares you with the way they play defense to take deep shots.
Well, they have to. They're trying to put pressure on, and so they're going to be caught in man-to-man situations. Sometimes they do zone pressure, sometimes, but more often man pressure.
McVay, the returner this time. McVay out into the open, sort of stumbled there. Maybe some extra yards if he hadn't done that. Still, though, Air Force will have good field position when we come back to Fort Worth. It's the Lockheed Martin Armed Forces Bowl, celebrating our servicemen and women and celebrating football from two good programs at the end of quarter number one. It's Cal 14, Air Force 7. Texas Day, and California with their Star quarterback Jared Goff, a tremendous touchdown pass on Cal's last drive, leading 14-7. Air Force having a hard time getting that triple option going. The Cal defense, after the first drive of the game, has been impressive.
We talked about the fact that they would figure it out in the first drive or two, basically the speed of the game, what you need to do when they start to understand their assignments, what's happening. It's incumbent now on Air Force to change this thing up. They went with some pitches early in the first drive that were successful. They've been sticking more to the inside game lately that has not given them positive results.
Well, their senior quarterback playing his final game, Carson Roberts, will drop back to pass. They're going to take another shot downfield. They have a man open. Nice delivery. A first down. Garrett Brown, the first completion through the air for Air Force. One thing about this team, they don't throw much. When they do throw, they take shots down the field.
They're over 150 in passing efficiency as a team, and part of the reason is the play action pass. Here they get the wheel out of the backfield, which is very difficult when your eyes are looking into the offensive line, quarterback, fullback exchange. You tend to lose the guys sneaking out of the backfield.
That was 23 yards. That's right around their average per completion for the year. So they take shots down the field. First down, Air Force. Owens with a more traditional running style play. You mentioned that, how they mix it up. A nice game for Air Force.
One of the things that, and I think the three service academies lead the nation in yards per pass attempt, which no surprise because they run it, Air Force, Navy, Army, and then Baylor. Surprise, surprise. The reality is the play action pass off of the option is one of the best type of play actions you can have.
So per attempt, per completion, however you break it down, when they do throw the ball, they get big chunks through the air against defenses geared up to stop the ground game. Now that triple option look, pitch, McVay with a blocker in front. McVay inside the 20, tripped up at about the 16-yard line by Trey Turner, the true freshman, who may well have saved a touchdown. That's a gain of 12.
And one of the things that happens, too, if you complete one of those passes, it makes the people in the secondary be a little softer. They have to take a second now to react. They don't react as quickly to the run, so they're not quite as good in run support.
That was a heck of a block, too, by the guy who caught the pass a couple plays earlier, Garrett Brown.
They have to do both or they don't get to play.
You don't play if you don't block at wide receiver at Air Force. Another pitch play, this time to the left side, and another good game and a touchdown, Air Force. That's Tyler Williams.
Nice response by Air Force coaching staff and the offensive players on the field. It all starts with Carson Roberts. He makes the decisions, puts them in the right play, and then executes the pitch, which is just like a throwing pass for a throwing quarterback.
Well, I think you said it. As soon as they completed one pass, things changed against the option.
Well, and they find what happens, too, with Air Force, once they find out what you're doing, they start to tailor their game plan to take advantage of where they can attack you with either the dive or the outside plays.
Brown had the big block to play earlier. Timothy McVay, the tailback, had a great block on that play. So what a response for Air Force after Cal's defense had toughened up. The Falcons use that option to tie the game at 14. So Air Force has tied the game 14-14. And they will kick it back to California. Coming toward the sideline, but it stays in bounds. So Davis has to pick it up. Davis gets hit hard right around the 20-yard line. Tomorrow on ESPN, Capital One Bowl Mania continues. The Birmingham Bowl, Auburn and Memphis at noon Eastern. And then the Belk Bowl, NC State, Mississippi State, 3:30 Eastern Wednesday on ESPN. Both games streaming live on Watch ESPN and the ESPN app. Paxton Lynch, probably his last game with Memphis. Ooh.
Another great quarterback that can throw it all over the park.
I think he's the guy who most draft experts, our guys, Todd McShay, Mel Kiper, feel like is in the most competition with Jared Goff for the first quarterback selected. Now taking another shot, incomplete. Down the left sideline, intended for Maurice Harris. As I mentioned, our draft experts, Todd McShay, Mel Kiper. Here's how they rank the quarterbacks for the upcoming draft.
And I've seen both of them. And Paxton Lynch has some measurables. He's so tall and really gifted. Jared Goff, though, the more I watch him, the more I like him. Connor Cook is the guy that's a question mark in my mind. Some people really love him. Some people aren't so sure.
And Carson Wentz from North Dakota State in the mix there, too.
I've heard that name. I haven't seen him on film yet.
Goff in the pocket with that delivery. Powell can't catch it. Incomplete.
Now, normally you'd be a little concerned. Third and 10, you're throwing two straight incompletions. But I don't think, again, with Jared Goff back there at quarterback, the question is whether or not you're going to get pressure from Air Force or coverage. And that's the big question in this situation. Do you put yourself in man-to-man situations across the board or go with some type of a zone pressure?
Cal's been a good third down team. And they've been that today as well, 2 for 3 so far. Muhammad is the tailback alongside Jared Goff.
Looks like they're playing zone to me right now. Oh, changed up, got the inside pressure.
Picked up nicely by the offensive line. Muhammad incomplete. Just led him a little too far. Muhammad could not quite catch up even with his speed. It's fourth down.
And that's a great job because they look like truly a zone team. They had the safeties dropping back deep. But watch those linebackers come up inside. And they come with some pressure just to make him feel like it. That ball is, though, thrown very, very well. It's like inches from being complete.
So a punt coming up for Cal. This one high and fairly short. Fair catch signal. Fair catch made. Good field position for Air Force when we come back in a 14-14 game. But Sonny Dykes, he did make a good point to us. I thought he goes, well, in my experience, okay, you do all the bowl activities. You remember them as fun if you win the game. If you lose the game, they don't stick as great memories.
They lose a little bit of value. There's no question. You got to win the game to feel good about it.
So he was preaching that to his team all week long. Air Force and Cal tied. And a little bit of a wrinkle in that triple option. Cal is there to sniff it out. And we're going to get a penalty against Air Force on top of it. Stephen McClure made the play there, the safety for the Bears. So that one went backwards even without the flag.
Boy, if that's a penalty from there, and it looks as if it is, that's a huge penalty.
That would be an interesting
during
decision
the play,
for
Sonny Dykes. Legal block in the back on the offense, number 72. That's a 15-yard penalty. Correction.
Yeah.
15-yard penalty, 10-yard penalty. Replay, first down.
Well, Matt ultimately got it right. 10-yard penalty, and they do accept the penalty. So Air Force will go back a lot farther.
Well, if you're going to, I would take that penalty against almost any team, but certainly Air Force, because the odds of them making 10 yards per play as opposed to their average of 4 yards per play is pretty good. And that's a huge break for the Cal defense because they were on their heels last drive.
First and 20 from about the 32-yard line. Roberts under center will pitch the ball. McVay cuts up field, but well defended. Nice open field tackle there. Right back to the line of scrimmage. Now Air Force fans a little bit upset at the end of that play. That's Kyle Cragen, the defensive end, who made that play.
And Dave, you hit it right on the head. You have to be able to tackle in space to stop the option, because they're going to, if you can't, they will exploit you with the pitch as often as they can. The whole design of this offense is a lot like spread them out. They spread you out with the action of the quarterback running to the edge and creating the run pitch option.
So on this play, second down and 19, Roberts goes into the shotgun. Roberts, a designed run, but Cal, I think, saw that one coming. Now a good block helps Roberts get to the outside. So that could have been stopped for no gain. It was Alex Norton who got a block on.
And pretty nice job by Carson Roberts. Pretty nifty move right there. He goes down, but puts his hand on the ground, keeps his balance, and makes it a more manageable now third and 12 or 13.
Yeah, still not where Air Force wants to be, but Norton, who picked off James Looney, the defensive lineman, who's really played well for Cal. Third and 13 coming up. Roberts again. Dancing around. Roberts stays on balance, but not for long. So California does a nice job again. Their defense, I think, for the most part, has played well in this game so far.
They've given two series, the first and the third or fourth, and they've done really well, alternate series. But usually they like to try to target Robinette in that situation because he's a big target. He's the most athletic, but they're not really right now. They're doing a great job in coverage.
Fourth down, Strabel will punt the ball back to the Bears. End over end punt and returnable for Davis. Gets to that right side to the 30. Now here comes a flag that's going to go against Cal. So we'll wait to see what the penalty is officially, but that one's going to move Cal backwards.
Looks like a block in the back.
During the return, illegal block in the back on the return team, number 18. That's a 10-yard penalty. First down, timeout.
9:38 to go in the first half from Fort Worth. Jared Goff and Cal with the ball when we come back.
Really nice job with the ball. They haven't thrown as much as I thought they would in this game.
Yeah, their first touchdown drive was really mostly based on the run game. Goff, 6 of 12. It hadn't been overwhelming statistically, but you do see in those highlights a taste of what makes him so good. They're going to throw on first down. He takes a hit, and the pass is incomplete. Man, he got driven backwards on that one. For more on Jared Goff, here's Allison Williams.
Yeah, Goff known for having tremendous footwork, and part of that comes to him naturally, but he has put in tireless hours working on it. Coach Franklin puts him through what he calls a Peyton Manning drill, and basically they call a play, and he has to go through his progressions, never moving his feet. He'll work from front side A-gap to backside C-gap with never taking an actual large step, part of that constant foot movement that Goff has become so good at.
That pass completed out to the right side. Yeah, never taking the big strides. You sort of shuffle around the pocket. They gave us a full demo of the Peyton Manning drill yesterday, and Goff says he's done it. He thinks every single day he's practiced as a Cal Bear.
Part of a warm-up routine, but generally quarterbacks get into trouble when they overstride, when they take too big a step. So the idea of gathering your steps, keeping your platform and base underneath you, and transferring your weight very quickly back and forth is what makes great quarterbacks. The great feet part is what sets that platform to deliver the ball.
First down after that completion. Pressure coming, and Goff gets rid of it and somehow completes it. That's not going to be a big gain, but that was a virtual miracle that Goff could even get the pass off. Jack Flohr was there with pressure right in his face.
And that was a great job by Air Force in creating the pressure, but Goff escaping it and then getting a completion, positive yardage on that play to set up, you know, manageable, well, second and eight, but it could have been very, very bad back then.
14-14, under 9 minutes to go in the first half. And they will hand the ball off. Watson with a nice hole. Watson to the 45 and even beyond. Finally pushed out of bounds. The ball came out of the end, but he was well out of bounds. So a nice gain of 18 yards on the ground.
And that outside zone is the staple of Cal's running attack. And it's just reach blocks by the entire line. It comes off, and there's always a play fake. Goff, after the handoff, will toss the ball or fake like he's throwing the ball down the field.
First and 10. They give it to Watson again. Another nice hole. Watson into Air Force territory. Stopped at about the 46, gain of 6.
Feels like they're going back to that first drive and really trying to mix in even run or two runs to a pass to keep that Air Force defense honest and not allow the blitz to be a factor.
And they are going quick tempo here. Second and 4. Air Force jumped. So this is a free shot for Goff. It is caught one-hand style. What a throw and what a catch. Maurice Harris along the sideline, and I think he caught it just purely one-handed.
No question. He just snatched that ball out of the air. This was a free play. Typically free play, you're going to go deep. So look at it from this angle. This ball is hung up in the air, and then, yeah, it's one. He just tipped it back to himself, tiptoed the sideline, and Cal is set up down at the 5.
Tremendous play. So the penalty was against Air Force, obviously declined. 40 yards to set up first and goal. That was spectacular. And that's what you want, right? When you have that free shot, go for it.
There's no question. That's what you've got to do.
Throwing on first and goal. Touchdown. Goff to Darius Powell.
And the success of the run game is what sets up that play. That's the same fake in terms of that outside zone. Everybody's running to the right, and the receiver just sneaks back behind the linebackers who are trying to get their fill inside to stop the run.
Second catch for Powell, his first touchdown. Cal goes back in front.
Nice job. Some of those things look very, very easy, but part of it's because of the touch of Jared Goff.
No fake on the point after try. The kick is up and good. So Goff, he knew he had a free shot. He went down the sideline, and one play later into the end zone to Powell. It's 21-14. Part of this Lockheed Martin Armed Forces Bowl from Fort Worth, as Cal will kick it off very short. McVay will return it to the 25. Hit hard and the ball comes out. The ball's loose. And Air Force may well have recovered it. Cal had a player right in the neighborhood. But the Falcons get a break as they pounce on the ball. Nearly a turnover. Instead, Air Force will get the ball back. And I think it's McVay, after taking that hit, who is down and hurting.
That would be a big loss for the Air Force offense, because he's one of their best blockers and their best outside runners in terms of it.
Well, McVay, he's moving around, but he is obviously in a lot of pain. He took a big hit and the ball came loose. See if we can see that hit.
So it turns up in the seam right there, and then it's a perfect hit right on the football. That's the way you do it. Helmet on the ball, shoulder to the ball carrier. And we got him a little bit under the chin, too. That was difficulties on that. Two guys traveling full speed. That's a heck of a contact thing.
Darius Allensworth, the defensive back who made the hit that forced the ball loose. It is good news, I think, that McVay gets up and walks off. As you said it, if they lose him, that is a big weapon in their option offense. He's been their most productive ball carrier the last few weeks of the season. A first and 10. And the ball comes out again. This time after the fake dive, Roberts, the quarterback, tried to get it back, but he could not. So a near turnover on the kickoff return. This time, Cal, first play from scrimmage. Kyle Cragen comes up with the football. The Bears do get it.
Art Kaufman talked about the fact that they need to not penetrate too much, stay on the line of scrimmage, make them read us. And that what happens, get the big hand inside there, knock it out. Marcus Manley doing a great job of seeing the ball, just swiping it out of the quarterback's hands as he tried to get it back to make the pitch.
Well, that is a big, big play in this game. After Cal goes ahead, now they get great field position. First turnover on either side. With still 7:24 to go until halftime, but the Bears are in prime scoring position with Roberts and the Air Force offense back on the sideline.
Opportunity now for Cal down here to go up by two scores, and that's huge against a team that doesn't score quickly in Air Force.
Almost a pistol formation, a play fake. Goff has taken a shot, and the pass is right there. Touchdown. Kenny Lawler, his 11th touchdown of the year. One play after the turnover, Goff and Cal, 24 yards to extend the lead.
And they didn't waste any time. That is a perfect throw, and Kenny Lawler has range as a receiver. He's a guy you love to throw the ball to, because he's going to catch it wherever it is. He's got athleticism, he's got decent speed, he's got size, which creates a tough matchup for the secondary of Air Force.
Third touchdown pass of the first half for Jared Goff. Extra point is up and good. Well, we asked Goff about his many targets. He's got so many options. He said, well, they all have different skills, but the guy I'd love to go to in the red zone is this guy.
That's what I'm talking about, that range. And that's a perfectly thrown ball over the top of the defending corner, away from the safety, dropping it down in that, what I talk about, the basket. The basket, if you have to reach for it, it's right there to be caught.
Well, the pass to Treggs for the touchdown, the long pass along the sideline to Harris, that one to Lawler. all three as good as it gets from the junior quarterback, Jared Goff, who is showing off today in Fort Worth.
And Sonny Dykes wanting to waste no time. You get a turnover, take advantage of it, take a shot right there. They do it, they execute it, and they score on it.
Could well be the last game for Kenny Lawler as well. He is not a senior, so they got all those senior wide receivers who will be gone from Berkeley after this one. Lawler is a junior. He has a year of eligibility left, but he is a legit draft prospect, and a lot of folks think that just like Goff, this would be his last game with the Bears.
I would tend to agree. He's as good as any receiver in the conference, certainly one of the best in the nation. His numbers aren't great simply because they spread the ball around so much.
Now the kick return. It's Owens who will bring it back for Air Force across the 30, jumping high with some extra yardage. And I said Owens, it was Brian Driscoll, number 22, came back there with McVay, perhaps still dinged up after the big hit on the last kickoff return.
I'll tell you what, Air Force is doing a great job returning the kicks today. They're averaging out past the 35-yard line, and I've been very impressed with them against Cal. Cal's got to shore up that special teams a little bit. Not that they, if they keep scoring, they're going to have to kick off a bunch.
Problem for Air Force is now they're down two touchdowns after the turnover. 7:07 to go in the first half. Still a long way to go in this game. They do get McVay back in the game, so that's good news for the Falcons, but this is not a come from behind team.
Right, and they can't change their game plan. They're going to try to do what they do, take time off the clock, try and get a score right here, get it down to a one possession game, hopefully not leave any time for Cal to score. So getting back to what they do, mix it up, quarterback carrying the ball, let's pitch it outside, let's run the dive to keep the defense honest.
One of the best keep plays for Carson Roberts in this game, a gain of 8 or so on first down. Goff still on the sideline after a one-play drive. Didn't have to expend a lot of energy on that last one. Another keeper for Roberts and a first down out close to midfield.
Yeah, they vary. That was a tackle over. They had a tackle, extra tackle on this side of the field. You take a look and see it. As they line up, you see the two tackles on the left side of the line. This is the short side of the field. So they have a lot of ways to exploit what they do, see how you line up, and then Carson Roberts is the key. His decision-making, his choice of plays at the line of scrimmage is what makes him special.
Three wideouts in this formation, at least at the start. Brown comes in motion. They're going to throw back to Robinette, who's going to throw it himself. And the pass is knocked away, incomplete, intended for McVay. Well, Robinette, in a designed play there, they threw it backwards to him. He took a shot downfield. That was a pretty good pass, but Darius Allensworth was right there.
Did a great job, and the pass just hung just a little bit. But they talked about this play, that they were going to do this. And it's a penalty on the play.
Second down.
No penalty. Allensworth with the coverage knocked it away. This is part of the field where you start to expect some of those tight plays if you're going to use one near midfield.
You're exactly right. I always had a play, a trick play as soon as we crossed midfield. Another one as soon as we got in the red zone. You have those. You practice them all year. You want to use them. You play. So when we practice it, we never use it. Well, we're going to use it now. It's a bowl game.
Second and 10. That option, the pitch with a lot of room. Great decision by Roberts inside the 40. Garrett Brown with the first down run.
People talk about keeping your eyes right in the secondary, and the reality is when they start one way and they come with the option back the other way, you start initially, you look at where the quarterback will open up, the play end up coming to the backside. If I take two steps the wrong direction in the secondary, I allow the blocking angles to catch up with me.
Dive, keep, pitch, Mike. Those are the three options.
Yep, yep, exactly. And I'll tell you what, they do a great job of keeping you honest.
A little pitch fake. Roberts rolling out, throws the ball in. I think that was a good decision.
Great decision. Great coverage by Cal. That's one of the things. That play is a little bit like standard traditional play action off of the sweep, dragging the tight end back across. And the reality is, as we see this, watch how they adjust to this. Watch them pick up the guys, see the inside linebacker turn and run with the tight end crossing. Everybody else is covered. Great decision. Roberts had no choice there but throw the ball away.
We We saw that breakdown of the triple option and the three choices that Air Force has. Cal's really done a good job against the dive, which they said was their number one priority. Those pitch plays, those have been the most successful plays. This time it's a keep. Roberts picks his way forward inside the 35, down to about 32.
You have to sort of pick your poison. If you're going to stop the dive, and then do you want the quarterback to carry the ball or the halfback? And typically, you're trying to stretch it out as far as possible. Make them run to the sideline. Don't give them the vertical outlet to get upfield and get positive yards.
Could be four down territory for Air Force.
I think it probably is, no question.
Third and four here. Under 5 minutes to go in the first half, and now trailing by a couple of touchdowns after a costly turnover. Roberts will pitch it. That's McVay. Nice cut. McVay to the 20, to the 15. And Timothy McVay looks healthy and spry. Big gain, first down, Air Force.
And great job for Air Force coming back from that incomplete pass to put them behind the sticks. Here in a fairly short yardage situation, see what the dive, how many people it attracts, and then great blocking on the outside to free McVay up.
That's 19 more yards. Griffin, one of those blockers, I think, the tight end, who's a good player for Air Force.
He's sort of an unsung hero. He's a great receiver, especially in the red zone. He's got three touchdowns, but he's a great blocker. They love him, love the matchup of getting him on a linebacker.
Roberts keeps it, and this time goes nowhere. Maybe got a yard to set up second and long.
And you know, when the quarterback does that and takes, almost goes down, it's because they've got coverage on the pitch guy.
There is a flag, Mike, and it came a long way from the play, a long way from the ball, came in the back of the end zone.
After the play was over, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 6 on the defense. Half the distance to the goal, automatic first down.
That's Darius White in coverage with Jalen Robinette, and it was after the play.
Well, and yeah, it's like I said, when you go to the face and you get blocked, and Air Force plays with an intensity that sort of angers people sometimes when you're playing against them, because they don't give up. They continue to push and push and push, but you can't be the guy that retaliates.
Yeah, I mean, you could see why Darius White reacted that way.
He got blocked in the back out of the end zone, yeah.
40 yards from where the ball was. But it was that retaliation that got the flag. First and goal, Air Force. Owens gets the carry, and a nice run for Owens all the way to the goal line. Stopped a little bit short. They spot him just barely short. Second and goal.
And this is actually a fairly quick drive. This is only about a 3-minute drive for Air Force, but they didn't want to leave this much time on the clock. Don't be surprised if they take a couple plays to score here.
Did Troy Calhoun figure out a way to take 3 minutes and 20 seconds to get a half a yard?
That I don't think so. And as I say that, as a coach, score any way you can.
Well, Air Force thought they got in on that play, but no review. Roberts pushes ahead. Touchdown. Well, that was an important drive for Air Force. After falling behind by 2 scores, they march down the field and punch it in from 1 yard out with their quarterback, Carson Roberts.
This is an amazing game in terms of the ebbs and flows. I keep thinking somebody's taking control, taking charge. They're starting to pull away, and then all of a sudden, boom, it's Cal or it's Air Force now stepping back up, making it a one possession game.
And that penalty, I mean, that was a significant call. Again, you understand Darius White's reaction, but that was huge. 10-play drive, high snap, good hold, and the kick is good. Back to a 7-point game. After Roberts and Air Force go 64 yards down the field for their third touchdown of the first half.
Now, this is plenty of time left for Jared Goff and the Cal Bears and that talented group of receivers. They still are a difficult matchup for Air Force in a man-to-man situation. So they have to be very careful about how much blitz they do.
So one last word, probably with his offensive coordinator, Tony Franklin. And now getting ready to come back on the field. Well, the junior who grew up in the Bay Area, grew up in Marin, just north of San Francisco. His mom, his dad was a great baseball player at Cal, played Major League Baseball, but both are Cal grads. Jared grew up as a little kid going to watch Cal football, going to Memorial Stadium. So as he has said many, many times, for him, coming to Cal and helping revitalize the program was a personal thing. He was all in from the time he was very little on Cal football. And I think he can be real proud about the way this program has bounced back from some very lean years.
There's no question Sonny Dykes put this program on his back the last couple of years.
Kickoff, and Davis will be the return man inside the five. Cuts it to the right side and gets tackled at about the 21-yard line. The New Year's Six, two of the greatest days for college football fans, and it all starts at noon Eastern on New Year's Eve on ESPN. That is Houston and Florida State in the Peach Bowl. Then at 4 and 8, the playoff semifinal games, Oklahoma, Clemson, Michigan State, Alabama. Then even a day after those on New Year's Day, three more great games to kick off 2016. All of them on ESPN and streaming live on Watch ESPN and the ESPN app.
Oklahoma, Clemson. Great game. I think that'll be the closest game, and I think the winner of that game goes on to win the whole thing.
Wow. Watson with the swing pass, complete from Goff, and a nice cut to get close to the first down. We'll go down on the field to Allison Williams.
The message to this Air Force defense, you're better than you've shown so far. You have to keep playing. No one said it was going to be easy, just said it would be 60. Up front, guys, they have to find a way to get off their blocks and make a play. And the back end, I think you're really seeing the effects of them being without safety Weston Steelhammer. He is their best player, also their vocal leader. The safeties were told you can't just go out there and play. They have to communicate. It's tough without that guy back there.
Second and one, and Cal's going to throw the ball on second and short, and they're taking a deep shot down the field with that strong arm. Craig's in stride with the catch. And another spot where maybe they miss Weston Steelhammer inside the 15-yard line for Cal. That's 55 more yards for Jared Goff.
And you can't allow Jared Goff to stand back there this long and allow his receivers to have that much time to work one-on-one against the defenders. It's not a good situation for Air Force. They're probably going to have to dial up some pressure, try to make him get rid of the ball quickly.
Brody Hicks, the other starting safety, with the coverage, and he made the tackle, but here comes Cal. Still more than 2 minutes to go until halftime, right down the field. Goff takes the snap. Goff taking a shot, and he's got his man. Touchdown. Kenny Lawler, his second of this game. And Cal is an extra point away from putting up 35 in the first half. That one from 14 yards out.
And Air Force trying to bring pressure, but the reality is the Cal offensive line right now is solving the problems and the issues with the blitz. They're blocking him very well, allowing Jared Goff to take the time to survey the field and find the wide open receiver. Nobody in his face, he can step into the ball, and great separation by Lawler on his right.
Extra point is good. Fourth touchdown of the game for Jared Goff, his 41st of the season. In what is likely the last game of his remarkable Cal career, and he is playing great. So Goff and Cal back up by 35-21. Coming up on our Coke Zero halftime report, well, you were mentioning that Orange Bowl matchup that you love, Reese. Butch and Joey are going to talk about the Clemson D against the Oklahoma offense and the Cotton Bowl. Connor Cook will be very key for Michigan State. They're going to need him to make plays.
Very much. That Alabama defense is probably the most dominant aspect of the entire playoff system. And I think in order to derail them, Connor Cook has to play a great game and make great decisions.
Goff and Cal playing a great game on offense. Air Force has played well themselves offensively. They've scored 3 first half touchdowns, but they're back down 14.
Nobody's going to pass up the chance to score, but the reality is now we're going to see a couple touchdowns in the last 3 minutes of the half. And Air Force, this is actually enough time. They will probably go in somewhat of a hurry-up mode. They won't throw the ball anymore, but they can get off big chunk plays on the outside. They just have to be aware of the clock.
Well, one thing, Mike, you and I talked about at the outset, Air Force wanted to shorten the game, shrink the game. Cal has had the ball 7 times already. This will be the 8th possession for Air Force. I'm not sure that squib kick was executed exactly the way that Cal wanted it. Air Force will have it starting at their own 31-yard line. The Progressive Bowl Challenge Cup here at the Lockheed Martin Armed Forces Bowl, awarded to the conference that has the highest winning percentage in the postseason. Good start for the Pac-12, and Cal may be on their way to a 5th league win for the Pac-12.
Pac-12 has done a great job so far in the matchup. Interesting to see the SEC and the Big 12 have not played yet. So they can still come back and be a factor in this thing.
Pac-12's posting a score before those leagues get started.
Exactly. They're giving something to shoot at.
Cal does get the ball first in the second half. So Air Force would love to get some points here. Nice catch on the pitch from Garrett Brown. But he gets back to the line of scrimmage. Maybe, maybe not even that. And the clock winds, so not a lot of hurry up from Air Force here.
Yeah, and they may not. They may want to decide to not put the ball back in Cal's hands, because typically you'd talk about in a two-minute situation, you want to get out of bounds, get a first down, or get a touchdown, and you can't take any sacks, and you don't want plays that go for less than 10 yards. And the reality is, I think the way Air Force is lining up and playing now, it seems as if they're going to be content to let this score stand for halftime.
Cal does have the two timeouts. That one was almost bobbled, and the pitch read well. Cal's going to drive Brown out of bounds, which will stop the clock. 1:05 to go.
With this situation, you're right. With those two plays now, Cal should be considering calling their timeouts, because they'll have a shot here to either try to block a punt or, you know, get a couple plays off offensively.
Well, third down here. I mean, Cal's drives have been fast. They're five touchdown drives have all been under 3 minutes in total time. So we know they can strike quickly. And Bryce Dregs and company, they're staying loose. They're hoping to get the ball back.
It's timeout.
And now Cal will use that timeout. Just what you were saying.
Actually, I think Air Force took that timeout. I think they were not sure of the play they wanted.
So Air Force is going to use the timeout. The clock never did start again, so Troy Calhoun wants to be organized and maybe, Mike, mostly to avoid making a mistake, because I mean Air Force knew what they were facing coming into this one. They knew it was going to be tough to stop Goff and Cal, but they've seen it up close and personal.
Right, I think they want to recheck and not take a chance on this next play, because I think they understand what kind of time is left and not risking turning the ball over to a fairly hot Cal offense right now down in this end of the field.
I would say, and if it is the final game, and it almost certainly is for Jared Goff, I mean, so far he's showing why he'll be leaving Berkeley and heading straight to the NFL as a very high first round pick.
There's no question, because he's done it behind an offensive line that, as you said earlier, hasn't played as great maybe as anticipated or hopefully they could, and he has done a tremendous job, accumulating over 4,000 yards, and when everybody knows that's exactly what they're going to do.
The third and 14. They'll pitch it to McVay. McVay will get tackled from behind by Hardy Nickerson. And an immediate timeout for Sonny Dykes. A Cal defense will head back to the sideline after coming up with the stop. Still 58 seconds on the clock.
Yeah, they're going to get a couple shots at it and see what happens. Obviously, a good return would help. But the reality is, depending on where they get the ball, they'll need, say, 30 yards or so to get in field goal range, and then, you know, something more beyond that, obviously, for a touchdown.
Now you play the whole sequence back, and maybe Sonny Dykes would be remorseful that he didn't use that other timeout after the first down play. As it turned out, they shoved Air Force out of bounds, which gave them sort of a free timeout. I think they were saving that second timeout. Now they have it when they get the ball back.
Yeah, and I think that play was very fortuitous for Cal in terms of getting the running back out of bounds, because you're right, it did save them a timeout. Puts them in a situation now where they have a little choice, some choices to do.
And Trevor Davis has had some return room as well in the punt return game. This one, not a great punt again. And returnable. Davis, though, is going backwards, looking for a block. We'll get that block across the 40, out to the 45. Great field position for Goff, who has been spectacular.
Yeah, plenty of time at this part of the field. Goff, they're running a no-huddle, hurry-up offense anyway, and they've thrown the ball down the field very comfortably against the matchups in the Air Force secondary. So look for them to go, and this is a situation we talk about. First down, out of bounds, or touchdown. Get down, throw it away, do not take any sacks.
Just 23 net yards after that punt and return. So that helps Cal even more with 46 seconds on the clock. And we'll see. Goff in the pocket will take a deep shot into coverage. It's incomplete, but the flag thrown. In fact, two of them. Brody Hicks put the hit on Muhammad, the back who was the intended target. And maybe that contact just came early.
Yeah, I'm not sure why he even did that. The ball was so far overthrown, it's uncatchable, and it was not a good idea, not a good.
There are fouls against both teams, holding on the offense, number 75. Pass interference on the defense, number 18. Those penalties will offset. Replay, first down.
Well, in the end, that's a good result for Air Force because, 7 seconds wind off the clock, and they'll have to go back to where they started.
For Air Force at this point, trying to finish, tackle the ball inbounds. Make him throw underneath. Don't give you anything over the top. Brody Hicks, I'm not sure he should have been playing the ball more there as opposed to the receiver.
That's what we were talking about with Cal, their quick strike ability. All of their touchdown drives in this first half have been relatively fast. This one has to be ultra fast.
And they have no fear. They haven't had any problems with the Air Force blitz so far today.
Yeah, almost none. Here comes the pressure. They throw a slant. And that's defended well by Air Force. That's exactly what Air Force wants. Now Sonny Dykes does have that final timeout. So that helps in that spot. He burns it with 31 seconds on the clock.
That's a 30.
And that was actually a wide screen. They were hoping jailbreak screen type thing. They actually let the blitz. They read the blitz early. Great play call going against the blitz to try to throw that, because if he gets off the mark and gets going, got a chance. The question now is where the field goal range is. I assume they got to get somewhere around the 25-yard line, between the 25 and the 30, to try a field goal. But they've been very comfortable throwing the ball down the field. I mean, not 5 or 10 yards, but 30 and 40 yards. And his comfort zone throwing the deep pass, we've seen it already today. Jared Goff ready to go.
Well, Matt Anderson, their place kicker, he has kicked a 48-yarder this year, so they might be comfortable trying it out to about the 35 or so. In that case, they would need to get a couple more first downs, 20, maybe 25 yards, to have a realistic shot at it. No timeouts now remaining. There's Matt Anderson, the sophomore, who has made 10 field goal tries in a row.
I think the question is whether Air Force chooses to blitz, make him get rid of the ball, or try to pressure him with 3 or 4 and play coverage.
On second down. Well, they are bringing some pressure. Yep. And Goff will not get away. That's huge for Air Force. Ryan Watson comes up with the sack, but he had help.
Yeah, that was bring the ranch, get after him. Did a great job, and he kept contained. One of the key things when you blitz is to contain the quarterback. Don't let him get outside the pocket. Make sure that the outside guys stay outside.
Well, and Cal's not even going to try. Hey, you're the school of Aaron Rodgers. Why not try a Hail Mary from the 35-yard line? But no, they won't even run a play. They will go to the locker room. They get the ball to start the second half. And I think the Golden Bears have to be pleased with the way the first half went.
No question. It was up and down, but their athleticism, the matchup of their receivers against the secondary of Air Force without a significant pass rush, Jared Goff has done a nice job.
Sonny Dykes down on the field with Allison Williams.
Coach Dykes, early on, we saw you guys run the ball a lot offensively, open things up a little bit more as the half has gone on. How would you describe the way your offense has developed here so far?
Well, we've made some big plays. We haven't executed probably as well as we'd like to. You know, we got a chance here at midfield to score at the end of the game and get sacked. We've done some good things, but we haven't been as consistent as we need to be.
Defensively, first time facing the triple option, how do you think you guys have done?
Well, we've done okay. You know, we're trying to make adjustments, and Air Force does a great job of adjusting. They always try to stay one step ahead, and you know, they've done a good job cracking some of our guys, and we've got to get an answer for that in the second half. But right now we're playing hard, and you know, we're gonna get the ball to start the second half, so it'll be good.
Sonny, thank you.
All right, thanks.
All right, Allison and Coach Dykes, we appreciate that. Now time to go to Reese Davis. It's the Coke Zero halftime report. And Cal gets the ball first to start the second half, 15 of 22, after kind of an up-and-down start, 277 yards, 4 touchdowns for a guy who's going to be a first-round pick, for a guy who will likely be playing his final game in a Cal uniform. And I don't think it'll take all that long to find out what the decision is after this one is over.
The biggest difference for me in this game, though, is Air Force's inability to capitalize on the play-action pass. They're 1 out of 5 passing. They've got one decent play, but they have to make more plays to supplement their run game.
Trevor Davis right near the goal line will return the kickoff to start the second half for Cal. Davis at about the 25-yard line. Let's welcome in once again Allison Williams.
Well, a focus for Air Force defensively, stopping big plays that we've seen Cal have in that first half. And while the coverage does need to be better in the back end, especially without safety Weston Steelhammer, who was ejected early in this game, Coach Calhoun told me that they actually need to get better, do a better job up front of getting that pressure and getting it home, getting to Goff and disturbing him. They've got to be better up front. As for offensively, they have to do a better job getting first downs and sustaining drives, so they need better blocking up front.
Well, thanks, Allison. And Mike, Goff's been spectacular. It has not helped that Weston Steelhammer, who might be Air Force's best defensive player, targeting penalty very early in the game and has not played since then. As Air Force forces an incomplete pass on the first play from scrimmage of the second half. This is that targeting penalty.
Yeah, and this was probably uncalled for, didn't need to do it, and it was close, but the reality is, when in doubt, it is a penalty, and it caused the ejection, and he's their leader in the secondary, their emotional leader on defense. He and Alex Hansen are the two guys they look to for leadership to make plays, and he's gone now. He's been gone since the first series.
Second down for Goff and the Bears. A play fake. And that one is complete to a guy who's been pretty quiet in this game, Steven Anderson, normally a big weapon for Cal. That's another Bears first down.
And that was too easy. There was no pressure whatsoever. Anderson went across, found a hole in the zone, and Jared Goff, too accurate a quarterback to give him that much time.
They will hand the ball off to Trey Watson, but the play is blown dead. A flag before the play. That's going to be a false start against Cal.
And that saved Air Force right there.
False
I don't
start.
Know if they were ready.
On the offense, not all 11 players got set. 5-yard penalty. First down.
We've talked about that before in this game. That's the staple of the Cal running game, the outside zone from the shotgun, and it is just a give, and everybody reach to the right, and they do a great job of running it. And then what it does is set up the play action coming off of it that can gash you down the field.
So maybe a little break for the Falcons, first and 15. Watson still in the backfield alongside Goff, who will throw. That one is caught across the middle by the second tight end, Raymond Hudson.
Same play they ran two plays ago, same play that comes off of the outside zone reach play that we just discussed. And there's the linebackers running to fill, trying to match it, and then they vacate the interior area. And right now, Cal's receivers are too good for the secondary and the coverage people of Air Force.
11 more yards for Goff. That puts him over 300 for the game already. Just a couple plays into the second half. Watson, that left side run, does get stopped short of a first down, so it'll be third and two for Cal.
This is still third and two is what you love as a offensive coordinator, because it opens up the entire playbook. You can run it, you can throw it. If you have off coverage, you can take the easy throw to the outside. You may want to prove something and have your offensive line get that first down for you just to make them feel good.
Cal's got 35 points. They've only had four third down tries in the whole game.
That speaks to their big plays, and they've been the master of the big plays today.
So play clock winding down, third and two. Goff will hand it off. Watson gets the first down. Not by much, but they only needed two. They got three.
And off the draw fake, which allows the defensive line to sort of start upfield and take their pass rush routes, and then the offensive line just pushes them out to the side and creates the lane for the running back to find space.
First down right near midfield for Sonny Dykes and his Bears team, looking for their eighth win of the year. It's been a while since they've been in a bowl game. One player on this roster had ever played in a bowl game. Goff takes a hit but delivers the ball perfectly. Harris along the sideline with the catch. Dexter Walker put the hit on, but Maurice Harris with another big play. That's 15 more yards, and Cal will rush to the line of scrimmage.
And Walker coming unblocked off the edge. This is why Jared Goff is a potential first-round guy, because he can throw it under pressure accurately down the field with a quick release.
He is really good against pressure. He has taken a lot of hits in his Cal career. He's got an open receiver, Harris again, who makes a nice stutter step move. That was going to be a gain of five. Now it only got him a couple, maybe three extra yards, but it looked pretty.
And watch out, because Goff seems to be in a rhythm in this series. He's thrown, I think, consecutive passes on time, accurately, moving the ball right down the field. And watch out. Air Force has to do something to get him off his mark or disrupt that comfort zone.
Made that move against Roland Latipo, who is a good cover player. We haven't called his name much. I think Cal has steered their offense away from him.
He's their best cover guy and the most aggressive. And sometimes people work double move routes on him because he is aggressive on the first break.
A running play with basically nobody there, and where he lowers the shoulder pads and gets right near and will get with the forward progress a first down.
It's an interesting play. Sometimes Cal will run that outside zone away from the way the line blocks, and it's in case the defense is keying, and really it's a naked lead play to the tailback. Good luck to him. See how brave he is.
Well, those numbers sort of speak to what we were talking about against five-man rush, so against extra pressure. Those are spectacular numbers from Goff. He thrives in those spots.
They are, and that's why it's almost scary to try to pressure him.
He'll take a shot down the field. Hudson sort of stopped his route. Now Goff took a shot at the end of the play, and I think that's going to be a penalty against Air Force. And Jared Goff is slow to get up. He does get up.
I think he'd only get hit. I think his own guy landed on him.
Personal foul, roughing the passer. Defense, number 97. Half the distance to the goal, automatic, first down.
As we watch the end of the play, you can see this right here. He's going to get thrown down, and then his own guy is going to slip and fall on him, which probably wasn't. I don't think either of those were that tough. Goff, the other thing he does, he gets thrown down, but he does a great job of protecting his body to the ground. Some quarterbacks land uncomfortably, and you go, wow, that's going to hurt him. Goff a lot of times has the ability to just roll with the punches like a wrestler or a boxer coming out of something.
Well, if Coppola had just sort of shoved Goff, maybe there's no penalty flag. The fact that he body slammed him at the end of that tackle, I think, is why the flags were thrown. So they'll march off the penalty distance inside the 15-yard line down to the 12.
I think that's the first time he's got a hold of him all day. He wanted to make a statement. And obviously they're talking about you have to disrupt the playmaker for the other team. That playmaker is Jared Goff.
That is a big penalty. It's first and 10, not quite first and goal for Cal, trying to expand their 2-touchdown lead. First possession of the second half. Goff, play fake. Over the middle, he's got his man, Powell, touchdown. Fifth touchdown pass for Goff already in this game. 12 yards. That's the second one for Darius Powell. It's 41-21.
Cal pulling ahead now, and Jared Goff the catalyst for that. Watch the play fake here, then the quick release. Quick release, accurate throw, under pressure with the play fake. That's the things that make him a great quarterback.
Extra point is good. It's 42-21. And it's been Jared Goff and the Cal passing games game. They lead big over Air Force. Cal is rolling here in Fort Worth as the Bears have opened up a 42-21 lead in this Lockheed Martin Armed Forces Bowl. What other bowl do you get a helicopter at your tailgate? That's pretty cool. While we were away, General Mark Welsh, who is the Chief of Staff of the U.S. Air Force, the recipient of the Great American Patriot Award from Armed Forces Insurance. So congratulations to General Welsh. And thanks to him for his service to our country. Kickoff time, Cal took the ball first in the second half, went right down the field, scored a touchdown, 76-yard drive. So now the Falcons of Air Force get the ball back with another good kick return, and this one very good to the 35 and close to the 40. Brian Driscoll with the return for Air Force. Capital One Bowl Mania. Tonight, it's the Russell Athletic Bowl. When we're done here, North Carolina and Baylor, that's a top 20 matchup there. And the Advocare V100 Texas Bowl. Down the road in Houston, LSU and Texas Tech. Now 1-9 Eastern tonight on ESPN, also streaming live on the ESPN app. Bowl news and notes coming into today. It's been the favorites who have mostly prevailed. We had a lot of high-scoring games. This one is no exception. And I like to note that the 3-5-7 teams, everybody, all the grief about those teams, they played well, all 3-1.
A lot of motivation for those teams, but also couldn't you imagine playing against a 5-7 team in the bowl game? How do you get your team fired up to play somebody who doesn't have a winning record?
Obviously, that was a struggle this year.
I agree. I think right now, unfortunately, we have too many bowl games. I don't think 5-7 teams should be there, but congratulations to those that honored themselves by being there winning the game.
I will say this, if that's our biggest problem, that we have a few too many college football games, we're doing okay.
You're right. I have to agree, because I think that's why we get paid.
It's not a bad thing to have a few extra games. McVay, who's been beaten up in this game, has to leave for at least a play after a 2-yard gain. Now the question is, Air Force, can they keep up? Down 3 touchdowns. Their quarterback, their senior, Carson Roberts, stopped 2 yards short of a first down.
Execution for Air Force is gaining 4-plus yards per carry. And they do it by average. Now they're at 3rd-and-2, which is very manageable for them in this offense.
Well, Roberts, he's playing his last game with Air Force, and he's done a nice job. The senior from Houston, mechanical engineer at the Air Force Academy, who was not the starter at the start of the year. Nate Romine was hurt. Roberts, keeper, and I think he was stopped short by a yard, maybe a full yard. This will be interesting. Down 3 touchdowns. Do you have to go for it?
I think it's 4-down territory. For Air Force, I think they believe at any point in time they can make a yard, and it doesn't matter where they are on the field. And you still have to defend the dive, the keep, and the pitch. So this offense is built to gain 1 yard in any situation.
Now the leading tackler for Cal, Hardy Nickerson, on the sideline for this 4th-down play. And before that 4th-down play, Cal calls a timeout.
First charge, timeout, California.
So we'll take a timeout ourselves. 42-21, Cal leads here in the 3rd quarter. Now here on the field in Fort Worth, out of the timeout, it's a 4th-and-1 for Air Force, down 42-21. They need to get this one. Roberts under center will hand it off, and they are going to get it. Jacoby Owens, the fullback, with a run of maybe 3 when they needed 1.
Power run, they go to the left side, pull the lineman right there, and he just finds a hole, and he falls forward, which is the good thing. He makes sure by falling, pulling the pile forward, and that's what you'll have a great back to do in any situation.
It was going to be fairly close until he stumbled ahead and got it by a couple. A pitch play to the left side, and a nice cut by Owens, sort of stuttering forward. And he's going to get real close. He may well have gotten a first down.
Owens is unique for Air Force in that he was one of those halfbacks, one of those wingback type guys. They've moved him to fullback, and this year he's probably the niftiest fullback they've ever had. He's about just over 200 pounds, so not typically the size that they want, but he has a little niftiness, a little shiftability, and the power to make that position be very special.
Well, just a junior, second straight 1,000-plus rushing season for Jacoby Owens. You're right. They were not sure how that was going to go. They lost their 2 very high-quality fullbacks. So they moved Owens there, who gets the carry here. It is a first down. They had spotted him about a 0.5 yard short and more inside the 35 down to the 34.
They're lining up in an interesting formation. 9 people on the line of scrimmage, 1 quarterback, 1 tailback, and they're running. They're sort of counting and looking at where can they gain an advantage. So that was what they've done the past couple. Now they're back to their double slot, double wing look.
Roberts under center. Took a long time to get the snap. Now we'll pitch it. And a nice run for a first down and more. Still going inside the 20, inside the 15. Brian Driscoll. That was impressive.
Nice job, one of setting the play. Carson Roberts, he changed the play at the line of scrimmage, decided which way they need to go, and then the execution of the blocks at the end man of the line of scrimmage. You see Garrett Griffin there. We talked about his blocking ability down the field, and then the ability to tiptoe the sidelines and get more yards.
And just barely stayed in bounds there,
that
but apparently
close.
Did. So Driscoll is from McKinney, Texas. Now Roberts keeps it, takes a big hit, but gets down to close to the 5-yard line.
Roberts on the keeper.
It's not quite a goal to go situation. Air Force can get a first down before getting into the end zone.
Down here, Roberts becomes even more important because, as we talked about, you can pick up a blocker either through the option, half a man at the point of attack, or through the fact that the quarterback becomes a ball carrier, everybody else can block for him.
Ninth play of the drive. Pitch to Owens. Right side with a block out in front of the ball comes out, and then it rolls out of bounds. And they're going to say it's a touchback. So it rolled out of bounds behind the pylon. If it rolled out at the half-yard line.
The ruling on the field is the player fumbled the ball into the end zone. Therefore, it is a touchback.
Wow.
First down, California.
A terrible break for Air Force. That difference of behind or in front of the pylon meant third and goal Air Force. Instead, it's a turnover.
As we see it from this angle, there's only chances if his body hit down, but it was ripped out there while he was still going. That's exactly the definition of a touchback. Goes through the end zone and out of bounds. As you said, Dave, difficult, huge break for Cal and against Air Force.
So that's Air Force's second turnover. They knew they couldn't have those kind of mistakes. That one hurts as they were about to go in. Instead, Cal gets the ball back. Stephen McClure forces the turnover. We'll be back after this. Dave Fleming, Mike Bellotti, Allison Williams back here in Fort Worth. Cal up big over Air Force. Looks like your closet, Mike.
Yeah. Actually, I do have some shoes like that. Not quite that color, though.
You were telling me before the game that because of all your trips as a head coach to sort of cowboy boot country, you had a few of those.
I have some boots from various bowl games, and I'm very excited. I love cowboy boots. It's a little tough to take on airplanes.
Goff is going to air it out on first down, looking for Lawler, and it's out of bounds. Man, he made the catch along the sideline. Another beautiful looking delivery. Now, wait a minute. The official said incomplete and now is spotting the ball.
Yeah, they're pointing at a spot. I think he might be pointing the spot where it was out of bounds. But look at the throw. That's from the left hash or so, all the way to the right hash down the field. See if we can take a look at his right foot. Ah.
So they were looking at the divot.
Yeah, definitely out of bounds. Nice call by the official.
Good call.
On the spot.
I think the zoom proves it. On the line, just barely. Handoff on second down for no gain. After an Air Force turnover when they were going to the end zone, now a Cal player is down and hurting. That's Stephen Moore, the right tackle, a junior. So some concern for Stephen. See if we can spot where Moore gets hurt. He's obviously in a lot of pain with that left leg.
As we can see over here, that left side, he's blocking right on the edge, and he gets a guy pushed into him, roll over that left ankle knee area, which is always tough. You never know. An offensive line, you don't know how courageous those guys have to be, because it's not what you see in front of you that typically gets you hurt. It's what's coming from the blind side or the backside.
Well, his teammate Jordan Rigsby, who is kneeling down next to Stephen Moore, is making his 49th consecutive start today for Cal. Nearly a Cal record for most consecutive games started. And we asked Jordan yesterday, well, what's the secret? You stayed healthy your entire career. And he basically said, well, it's just luck. If you're an offensive lineman, any play you could get rolled up on just like that. And I think there's some toughness involved with Jordan Rigsby, too, but he's concerned about his friend.
Riggs, I actually know his dad, Craig Rigsby. He used to be the head coach at Butte Community College and the AD there. I recruited his older brother, who didn't come to play for me at Oregon, went to Cal instead. And long tradition of those kids going to Cal. But they're good football players, good athletes. And the dad is a big guy, too. So I'll tell you what, there's length in that family.
Well, Stephen Moore from Elk Grove, California. Part of what at times this year has been a beleaguered Cal offensive line. But again, they have played well down the stretch of this season.
Well, you don't go to a bowl game, have a winning season, have a record-breaking quarterback without being a pretty good offensive line. I think people, you know, want to set that bar so high because of what Goff has been able to accomplish, and they always ask for more. And I think it's good to challenge people, to be better, to say, hey, guys, that's not good enough. We're going to be better. These five guys have to be the best out there.
We saw number 59, Brian Farley. Looks like he'll be the guy to come in to take Stephen Moore's place for third down and 10. Five receivers, no backs. Goff all alone in the shotgun.
Spread them out, and then do you blitz or do you play some type of coverage? They have not got to Goff but one time today.
They bring some pressure. The throw is perfect. Powell with the catch and run. What a move to midfield. Gets a block to the outside and all the way down inside the 40. Spotted out of bounds. Almost right near that divot of Kenny Lawler at the 36-yard line. A gain of 44.
That's the best Powell has looked today. You can see him right there. Just beat the guy over the top. And a perfectly thrown pass. We talk about the fact that Goff could put it on the back shoulder of the defender where he can't see it, only receiver can, and then nice run after catch by Powell.
Well, you said the question, pressure or not pressure. I just don't think today there's a good answer.
Yeah, there isn't. When they try pressure, they're just not getting there, and I credit the Cal offensive line with doing a great job of blocking, and just the receivers are owning that secondary right now.
Cal.
Second charge timeout, Cal.
Before first down, has to burn their second timeout. We'll keep it here with 5:16 to go in the third quarter and send it down to the sidelines and Allison Williams.
One thing to watch when Cal has the football is how Goff communicates with his teammates. He has one-word calls for his offensive line, hand signals for his wide receivers that allows him to just adjust things on the fly at the line of scrimmage, whether he wants the line to slide a certain way or a receiver to run a certain route. It's something he learned from Tony Franklin's quarterback at Louisiana Tech, Colby Cameron, just to help him kind of operate and communicate within the system. Now, while it was a former quarterback of Franklin's that taught Goff this, Franklin has no idea what the words are, what the signals are, what they mean, and frankly, he doesn't really care. He said everything that Goff does is to help this team. He is so unselfish out there. I don't need to know what they're talking about or changing. I trust him that much.
I mean, it is amazing. Allison, Mike, we all do lots of games. I've never heard a coach put it that way. I don't know what the signals are, and I don't want to know what they are. I mean, I've just never heard a coach say that about his quarterback's communication. Goff, maybe there was a signal before that play, taking a shot down the left side, but it's incomplete, intended for Trevor Davis.
Actually, sometimes that's more popular than you think. I know a lot of, at Oregon, when I called plays, I never worried, let them have the signal. But look at the balance of what he's done in terms of where he's distributing the football. Maybe a little bit better going right up the middle, but wow. Just tremendous balance, 21 out of 30, 381 yards, 5 touchdowns, and most importantly, no interceptions, no turnovers.
So maybe it happens a little more often. Coaches just aren't real honest enough to admit it like Tony Franklin did.
Well, a lot of times we have the plays and we put names to them, but we let the kids figure out what the signals are to something that will resonate with them. I don't tell them how to signal this or how to signal that. I tell them what I want them to signal. They figure out what it's going to be, actually the hand signal, the visual, or whatever it takes.
And maybe that's the difference with Cal, because a lot of times those signals with Goff are, we're not doing the play that just got called. We're doing our own thing.
Yeah, yeah. A lot of great quarterbacks. What I figured out halfway through my coaching career was, find out what they like. Find out what they believe in and what they're good at. And don't force something down their throat. Let them call and make decisions at the line of scrimmage.
Third and 4 for the Bears. And they'll hand the ball off. Muhammad is going to get the first down. A nice cut up field down to the 20 and maybe a little bit inside the 20.
And one of the things that you find, too, that the Air Force defense is going to get worn down a little bit now as Cal possesses the ball a bit longer. They're used to their offense possessing the ball and giving them a rest on the sideline. The longer that Cal keeps the ball in this drive, whether they run or pass the ball, it's going to fatigue that Air Force defense.
Goff already has 5 touchdowns. He will hand it off again to Muhammad, right side running for a gain of a yard or so. So 381 yards, 5 touchdowns. We're still in the third quarter. His career high, Jared Goff, with all the huge numbers that he's put up in his Cal career, is 6 in a single game.
I'd say that's in danger, especially where they're at right now, because they love to take the play action shots when they get in the red zone.
Eighth play of the drive coming up.
Diamond formation has been a max protection formation for them.
With that extra tight end plus the big fullback McMorris, they hand it off out of that formation. Watson, tough running, broke a tackle, got tripped up at about the 12, so a couple yards short of a first down.
Great running by Watson. They talked about he's the best practice player that they have. He's become a one-cut guy, but that was power running right there, running through tackles. They're keying the safety. They get a safety down in the box to match the power formation, they're going to throw the ball deep. If not, they'll be comfortable to run the ball.
Big number 99 still in there. They'll play fake. Goff to the end zone and incomplete. Good play on the ball by the Air Force defense. And that's Latipo. They have not gone after him, and maybe that plays an example why he's a good player.
No, that was great timing because this was in the receiver's hands, but great job by the DB. Watch him go up through the hands, knock the ball out, just continue to fight, and that's all legal, and that's what a cornerback is taught to do, is read through the eyes and hands of the receiver.
Another really good pass by Goff, but Hansen could not hang on after Latipo knocked it away. So Matt Anderson from 29 yards. Field goal try, good snap and hold. The kick is also good. So it's 45-21. Cal expands the lead with 2:44 to go in the third quarter. And while we have a moment, let's send it back to the studio and Reese Davis.
SportsCenter right now brought to you by First Command. A.J. McCarron, Bengals quarterback, suffered a sprained wrist and not a fracture on the final play of last night's overtime loss to the Broncos. McCarron took over for Andy Dalton 3 weeks ago when Dalton injured his thumb. That's SportsCenter right now.
All right, Reese, thank you. 45-21, that's the Cal lead. 2:44 to go. Jared Goff may not quite be done in this game, although it's possible that he doesn't finish the game as Cal has extended this thing out.
Yeah, I think, I'd like to see the future of Cal football at the quarterback position. I'm always excited about that. But I also, you want to pay homage and due to a guy that has helped build this program the past couple of years in Jared Goff, and maybe give him a chance to get a record, break a record. I don't know what bowl records are, but we know that, you know, another touchdown would tie it, and second touchdown pass would break his all-time record.
Now, what do you think? I mean, Goff has not made it official, his teammate Stephen Moore being carted back to the locker room. But we're fairly certain this will be his last game at Cal. Do you let yourself as an athlete start to think about that as the game goes on? This is the last time I'm playing in this uniform?
I think you do. I think there's no question that you do. But I think you also say, if this is my last game, I want to go out on top. I want to play special. I want to make something happen.
Air Force will get the ball back tomorrow night on ESPN. Capital One Bowl Mania continues on. The Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl. Texas A&M and Louisville at 7 Eastern. Then at 10:30 out west in the National Funding Holiday Bowl. USC and Wisconsin. Sort of a mini Rose Bowl. The Pac-12 and the Big Ten at 10:30 Eastern.
Exactly. But who's going to play quarterback for Texas A&M? I think the top two guys have left, so they're down to the third string guy. That's a little scary for a bowl game.
That is a little scary. I found it interesting that when we were spending some time last night with Mac Brown, you were just lording it over him that in the Holiday Bowl matchup, Oregon-Texas many years ago, you took down the Longhorns.
Yeah, I was not lording it over him. I couldn't remember the score. He corrected me on the score about four or five times. I do know we won, and it was a very close game.
See, you won. You didn't need to remember the details. He lost. He remembers
That's
every
true.
Detail.
That's true. Statistics are for losers. Is that what they say?
I hope he heard that. See, just piling on.
He just tweeted me right then.
Yeah. 2 minutes to go plus here in the third quarter. Dave Fleming, Mike Pilati, Allison Williams from Fort Worth. Roberts will pitch it. And a nice push up front. First down carry for Brian Driscoll. One of the younger players, and for Air Force, sometimes a junior is a younger player. But this is an offense, this is a system where it's always been the upperclassmen who have dominated the carries, dominated the production. But with all the injuries they've had at those ball carrying spots, some of these younger guys have played very well.
Well, and nowadays, I think most teams have play people young. Don't redshirt them. I mean, I know that you can't sometimes, but the reality is everybody's got to be ready to play, and they work hard. Let's find a way.
Wide open, and the pass is complete. McVay will go all the way. Touchdown, Air Force. 57 yards. They don't throw it often. When they do, they throw it deep.
There's the play action shot that we talk about. It's hard to keep your eyes right all the time in the secondary. Started with a little bit of a play fake. They were looking at a receiver on the curl. They ran a guy right down the middle of the field. Nobody covered him. And obviously, when you're trying to defend the run, you get lulled to sleep a little bit against this offense.
So McVay, the halfback with the catch. 57 yards, just a three-play drive. He scored 9 out of their last 13 touchdowns as a team.
He's been hot lately. Yeah. The games I watched prior to this, he stood out to me as the guy that was making that offense go.
And he is just a sophomore, so he definitely counts as a young player. Air Force is going for 2 with a minute 30 to go and not in that triple option look, although I don't think they were.
First charge, timeout of the half, Air Force. That's a 30-second timeout.
Not totally organized there for that two-point try, so they have to burn a timeout. That hurts a little bit. Gives us a chance, though, to take another look at that touchdown.
Yeah, watch as this play develops. See the play fake a little bit right there. The quarterback backs out, and then they sneak a guy right down the middle of the field. It's McVay, and he's got the speed. Once he gets the ball in his hands, he's a danger go all the way, which he does, but set up by the focus of the Cal secondary on trying to stop the run.
Sophomore from the state of Ohio with the long touchdown catch and run. They don't redshirt at the Air Force Academy. That does not exist for them, which it definitely impacts the football program. So
it does, because they can't recruit a made-for-play athlete, the guy that's bigger and stronger and faster. They typically the group that they recruit from is more normal size. So by the time they're seniors, they can develop a little bit of strength and size, but there's still limitations in that regard.
So out of the timeout, they will go for 2 to try to make it a 16-point deficit. So you can see the logic behind going for 2. Roberts under center will toss it, and they get the 2-point conversion rather easily with Jacoby Owens.
Yeah, so to explain that a little bit further, and if they cut it to 16, they get 2 more, and you're going to see that opportunity again if Cal's things stand to 45, because they'll be going for 2 8-point touchdowns to tie this game.
Yeah,
smart idea.
I think it was the right decision. Now, the tough part will be holding Cal at that 45 number, but first things first, they convert on the 2-point play.
They need to come up with a big play on special teams or a big play on defense. Turnover, takeaway type thing. Because you're right, when you're down this much, although there's still a whole quarter to go plus, it's a lot of time in a game. But it's also a lot of time to defend Jared Goff and that potent Cal offense.
Well, it does, I think, perhaps extend how long college football fans have to enjoy Jared Goff in what is almost surely his final game. It has been a good one. 381 yards, 5 touchdowns, no interceptions, 9 different receivers have a catch. That's been the story of his whole career.
Yeah, he's spread it around, and they have a wealth of talent at the receiver position. I think 5 guys catching 35 or 40 passes. I mean, I can't tell you the numbers because it's so overwhelming, but he's the catalyst behind it. He's the guy that finds them. And he understands each receiver's the nuances of who he's throwing the ball to, about how much I can lead him out of the break, how much I can let his speed take over. That's a great accomplishment for quarterback to make each receiver be successful.
Davis, the kick return. Davis to the 30. And outside the 35, tackled at about the 38-yard line. See some good kick returns in this Armed Forces Bowl.
One of the things you always worry about is special teams in a bowl game, because you don't hit it live as much as anything else. And so oftentimes you're worried about punt returns and kickoff returns because you haven't practiced your coverage teams quite as much as you normally would.
Well, Jared Goff, Hardy Nickerson, lots of these Cal players, when we were chatting with them leading into this game, said how painful it's been the last few years to sit and be a fan and watch all these bowl games just sitting at home. So you know they're relishing the chance to play in this one. How about another deep ball and another catch for Bryce Treggs. Even with pressure, Jared Goff, just a perfect delivery. 41 more yards. He's up over 400 for the game.
He had to throw this one a little bit sooner than he wanted because he did get a little bit of pressure coming off the edge, but he's putting his ball out here. Treggs, he gets a hand on it quite, cannot keep his feet quite enough to get in the end zone.
Maybe an example of some of that footwork you were talking about with Goff as well.
He's so smooth. He makes it look effortless to make the play fake, to load his arm, to throw the ball down the field with accuracy. It's amazing, and that's why people look at him for the next level.
So there's their token run play. Now they can go back to throwing it.
Yeah, and that token run is just to keep the defense thinking, if I show run, you have to defend the run. It still creates the one-on-one matchups down the field that Goff is going to take advantage of.
Treggs, who I don't think he wanted to come out of the game, looking in sort of the scoring zone for another touchdown. He's up over 140 yards in his final game at Cal. Goff looked left, now throws right. Great delivery. Lawler will go all the way. Kenny Lawler, touchdown. That's his third of the game. This one from 25 yards. You know, you also talked about the eyes of Goff. I think he did it to the defense there with his look.
Well, he looked it off. Plus, it was a blitz situation. They ran the jailbreak screen. They ran it to perfection. And Lawler, we talked about his range. He makes a great catch on this. The pass is thrown a little bit high because there's pressure, but he reels it in and then reels in a touchdown run beyond that.
So he's got three of the six from Goff, who's now matched his single game career high. We got a quarter more to go. Extra point is good. It's 52-29. Let's see if we can spot all those things that you were talking about.
Take a look here. Here he is right here. The screen is coming to the right. See him look left to start with. Looks him off. Touch the ball over the top. And now it's Lawler off to the races after making a great catch at the line of scrimmage.
And even if it's just a fraction of a second of a slowdown for those defensive backs, it can make the difference.
It does. It freezes the free safety. It actually makes some of the defensive linemen alter their path to where his eyes go. And he's pulling them away from the screen, away from where he wants to throw the ball.
Goff asking, so how many is that now for me? Six? Is that six?
I know. I guarantee you, he is not asking that whatsoever. He didn't care about that. If it happens, it's going to happen. He's just going, he's paying, who hasn't caught a touchdown today? Who hasn't got one? I'll get it to
you. Better guess. Third time he's had six in a game. He's never had seven.
I'm going to talk about still, it's that number of zero interceptions right there. That's the big thing. That's the thing that every coach right now is excited about or would be excited about, especially at the next level.
So Goff and Cal, the passing game has been really, really impressive. And this is a guy who took his share of lumps. I mean, he made a lot of plays as a true freshman, but they admittedly just totally threw him into the fire. And he took a beating as a freshman. He was much smaller. He's not a huge guy anyway, at least in terms of, you know, bulk and stature. And he survived that and got better because of it.
It was a calculated risk, and Sonny Dykes was willing to take that risk because he knew there would be reward at the end of it.
I think it's been one of the most impressive parts of Goff. Sacks allowed has come down at a 36. I mean, 36 in a way kind of understates the pounding that he took as a true freshman.
The number of times he was hit, you're right.
He's been hit a few times in this game. But the smile would tell you that he's feeling okay. But that is a tough kid.
Yeah, he's tough, and like I said, he does a great job. He's learned how to take that punishment and how to escape some of that punishment too.
He was about 185 pounds when he showed up on campus, and he played right away. Air Force gets the ball back, and well defended the dive play. Cal's done that all game long. That has not really been there for Air Force, and that will be the final play of the third quarter. Now, we've seen Jared Goff and his skilled players all over the field shine in this one. One quarter away from a bowl win for the Golden Bears. Cal and Air Force, one quarter to go, 52-29. It's It'll be a chilly ride today. It has been cold these last couple days in Texas, but we cannot wait for those. As Air Force has the ball, 15 minutes to go in this one. Cal with the 52-29 lead.
Air Force looking to score quick as they did last time. And they're doing a pretty good job getting that ball on the edge. That toss sweep, that pitch play for them has been the most effective play in their offense today.
Well, for Air Force, their injured quarterback, Nate Romine, who started the beginning of the year, then got hurt. The way it works at the Air Force Academy, he had to stop out from school, essentially. So he left school for this semester. Just in a few days, he'll be back at the academy as a full-time student. They will apply for a medical redshirt, and they should have him for two more years starting next football season, as Roberts playing his final game with a nice delivery for a first down to Jalen Robinette, who is not shut out today. It had been a quiet end of the season for him.
First catch in three games, though, and he's the guy that they really would love to put the ball in his hands down the field because he's a tough matchup. But that's the first time they've been able to get him the football in three games.
Good player for a different program, running a different style offense. He put up big numbers at the wide receiver spot. They're going to target him again, and he'll have another catch. Robinette inside the 40 to the 37-yard line. Another Air Force first down.
Back-to-back passes? I don't know. Has that happened in the history of Air Force football? I'm kidding. I mean, but literally they're trying to find a way now to get back in this game and realizing that just the regular ground attack may not make it.
Robinette, who got up fairly slowly after that tackle.
He got wound around and pulled back over that knee or that leg during the course of the tackle, and it didn't look good, and I think it seems like more of a muscle strain up in his lower back, but he's not healthy, not feeling good. And that's not good because going to him twice in a row, he's certainly able to be matched up against anybody in the Cal secondary.
Yeah, I think you're right. He's holding that lower back. It's bothering him.
They list him at 6'4", 215. I mean, he's like Lawler, only bigger. He's like the answer for Cal in terms of a possession receiver with range, and he has the ability also to break tackles and make people miss in the open field.
Well, slowly making his way toward the sideline. He's a junior, so he's got another year as part of this program. A really good player.
Depending on whether or not, I think if Air Force scores here, I think that is more the need to keep Goff in the game. But if Air Force does not score, then I think the question is whether you give Goff a chance to go for some records, and it's potentially his last game of his career.
Yeah, well, one thing is there is some history on the line in terms of all-time bowl game touchdowns. He's already tied his personal career high in any game. And that's six touchdowns from Jared Goff, second most that anybody's ever thrown in the history of college football in bowl games. Only last year's Bahamas Bowl with Cooper Rush for Central Michigan. That pass is intercepted. Trying to take a shot down the middle of the field, Luke Rubenzer comes up with the pick. The former backup quarterback, now playing defensive back, intercepts Carson Roberts. That is the third Air Force turnover. And Goff will indeed come back on the field. And the point we were making about the possible history, those seven touchdowns, the most in the history of any bowl game. Goff with one more would tie that.
Yeah, and you see this ball float just a little bit too far down the field, led too far and overthrown in a sense, and that's thus interception. So you're right. So now we're not talking about just his personal records. We're talking about an all-time bowl record. I understand that. As a coach, I understand that completely.
52-29, still 13 minutes to go. They will hand the ball off, and Wary is their power back with a nice gain across the 15 to the 17. That's what we were talking about. Cooper Rush, it was just last year, seven touchdowns in that crazy bowl game. Three others alongside Goff have thrown six in a bowl game. Chuck Long's really stands out. That's the only one that hasn't been in the last few years.
No, and I don't know that Troy Calhoun would agree with us that he should stay in and throw for another touchdown pass or maybe two to get the all-time record. But the reality is that Sonny Dykes, and for recruiting and for Jared Goff, the opportunity certainly is there.
They'll hand the ball off once again, and Wary this time goes nowhere. But one thing is, there's 12 minutes plus to go. So it's not like you're talking about 2 minutes left, up 52-29.
No, and you know, Air Force scored in about 2 minutes last time they had the ball. So until this game is out of reach, I don't think there's any problem, because with the tempo at which teams can score and the ability to score, and Cal has shown that they can shut down Air Force only sporadically on defense. One of their best things is to keep this offense on the field or to score points.
Third and four here for Goff and his offense. Bring a receiver in motion, fake that jet sweep and dump it off, and Muhammad just drops the ball. Man, he had a first down and maybe a lot more, and he just dropped it, so it's fourth down.
Yeah, he was going to run for some yards there, and I think he knew that. He started looking to run before he actually secured the football. Nice touch pass. Surprise, surprise, by Jared Goff, hitting him right on stride with pressure in his face. Couldn't quite make that catch. A little bit of play action. You see him come up over the top. That was just, gosh darn it, he'd love to have that one back.
Only the second punt for Cal today. Cole Leiniger, the senior, has not been real busy. Gets pressured on that one, but gets the punt off. Fair catch signal. Air Force starts about their own 47-yard line. That's outside here in Fort Worth. We'll be back for more football right after this. As Air Force gets the ball back near midfield, trying to keep this a game. And you figure it's must-score time for Air Force and then some. They did finally force the second punt from Cal. Roberts with the keeper out into the open. Nice gain. And all the way down to about the 31-yard line.
Well, obviously good field position. This drive started, and I don't know that they're going to settle for field goals. I think they have to get touchdowns at this point in the game. But remember, one of their drives, too, ended up being fumbled through the end zone for a touchback. So Air Force has moved the ball relatively well on the ground.
I think that's the point you've made often in this game, as the dive play to Jacoby Owens. Cal's defended that one very well today. Gain of a yard. The Air Force is up close to 400 yards of offense. They have 29 points on the board. And even the 29 points with a couple bad breaks, it could easily be more points than that. The offense has not been the problem at all.
No, and they've done a great job, and they've figured out what Cal is taking away and then obviously what they can exploit. And typically it's been on the outside of that defense, the perimeter.
Second and nine. Roberts, play fake. And that one was a little bit high, incomplete. Robinette back in the game. Remember, he left banged up on the last drive. Couldn't quite catch that one.
Difficult, wide open on that pass, thrown a little bit behind him. Carson Roberts doesn't claim to be the most pure passer in the world, but he's a great combination of a runner, a passer, the decision maker at the line of scrimmage. And he stepped in when Romine got hurt early in the season, has done a very nice job leading him this year.
Robinette was disappointed in himself. I think most receivers feel like, get your hands on the ball, make the catch. Sort of a fake option, Robinette. That's exactly what he does there. Got his hands on it. Nice delivery from Roberts. First down, Air Force.
Yeah, I think that was probably a tougher catch in a lot of respects than the one that he couldn't corral earlier. This low one here comes across, and you see him getting down low, focus on the ball, and got the first down yardage, which was the key in any reception.
Air Force coming to the line of scrimmage a little more quickly than usual, with time running out, under 10 minutes to go. Another play fake. Roberts rolling, looking, and he just had nowhere to go with the ball. Well covered by Cal.
Well, he had Robinette early. He had to throw it on time, though, on a post break. The other safety was coming over, so he wisely threw the ball away. They need to get points out of this drive, and rather than put it up for grabs, I think it's very important.
So Robinette had the good catch on the play before. This time it was a fan.
Nice job. They might recruit that guy.
If it hits your hands, you're supposed to catch it.
Was he wearing gloves?
No, I don't think so.
Some of those gloves now, I think they're so sticky, they catch the ball by themselves.
Not that guy. He doesn't need any gloves.
Second, we don't need those stinking gloves. Come on.
That's the handoff to Owens. Artie Nickerson in on the tackle.
And as you said, they have done a great job of canceling the dive today. And I think we talked to Sonny Dykes, and he said, what is our goal on defense? It is stop the dive.
10 dive carries, 33 total yards.
Yeah, that's not the average they want. They want 4+ per attempt.
The pitch plays have netted 150 yards for Air Force. Well, an injury timeout. A defensive lineman is down for Cal. That's Marcus Manley. We'll be back after this.
If they're able to hold on, they'll be able to hoist the Armed Forces Bowl trophy. And it's a hefty one, weighing in at 60 pounds. And it's a pretty unique trophy because it's actually made from combat-tested metal and steel from all five branches of the United States Armed Forces. It's supposed to represent strength, honor, heroism, and sacrifice. A pretty unique trophy here for the Lockheed Martin Armed Forces Bowl. Guys?
Well, thank you, Allison. Not quite Cal's just yet. Air Force with the strike from Roberts to Robinette. His first touchdown catch of the game. It's 52-35. And now Air Force is going to kick the point after not go for two. Second touchdown pass for Carson Roberts.
Robinette breaking out in a big way, held without a catch for two games in a row, and he's just become a guy now that could bring them back.
Well, seven play drive, took 2 minutes. Air Force knows they have to go more up-tempo than they like to, and they did that time for the touchdown pass.
Yeah, you can see the play fake here, and then Robinette on the crossing route, the safety falls down. They influence him with the guy crossing his face, and a nice pass. Very accurate throw by Roberts, and nice catch and finish by Robinette.
One thing, I mean, look, it's totally different teams, different programs, really, but the last time these two teams met in this bowl game, it was all the way back in 2007. Cal was down 21-0 in that game, and they came from behind and won. So there's at least some history, again, different teams, different circumstance, of a big come-from-behind win in this matchup.
Well, I would never count out either one of these coaches or these teams in that regard. Here is Cal coming back, and I think they switched quarterbacks, as I remember reading. Is that DeShaun Jackson?
That's DeShaun Jackson. He was pretty good.
He's pretty good. He's the guy that you could throw the ball to and count on a few scores. And the Calhoun team, they're never out of it. They have ways. And like I said, watch out for some special plays on the kicking game because they've got to make something happen.
Well, Cal fans will never forget that game. That was the Kevin Riley game. Kind of a pooch kickoff here. Cal will return it across the 30, close to the 35-yard line. Cal was definitely expecting an onside kick. After tonight's Advocare V100 Texas Bowl, stick around for SportsCenter at Night Live from Los Angeles. Stan Adeel have highlights from all the bowl games, NBA, NHL, college hoops. After LSU Texas Tech, it's SportsCenter at Night on ESPN, streaming live on Watch ESPN and the ESPN app.
Jared Goff back in the game, obviously, and as long as Air Force continues to score, I think we're going to see Goff in the football game.
Has a chance with one more touchdown pass to tie the all-time bowl game record with his seventh touchdown. He's already thrown for six. He will hand off here on first down. Muhammad, some tough running out to the 40-yard line.
This is a little bit different. Cal now considering, I think, running the ball, running the clock, take a little time off. You have a sizable lead, but Air Force has scored fairly easily the last couple times or threatened to score. So I think it's important to maybe run the ball, run the clock. That doesn't mean that they won't throw the play action pass, though, with Goff back there at quarterback.
And I think this is part of what you're talking about, where they can get to the line of scrimmage quickly, but then still let some time tick away.
Probably snap that ball under 10 seconds, I would think, for sure. Maybe under five.
Yeah, they snap it with about three to go on the play clock and hand it off to Muhammad again. Another nice run to midfield and down to the Air Force 48-yard line.
We talked about the fact that both Enwari and Muhammad down the stretch have become great running backs, and they use them all. Trey Watson started the game. Flasco was the big guy last year, but they've got depth at both running back and wide receiver. Problem is, there's only one football.
A lot of skilled talent on this Cal team. Now that's been part of the what-if game for Sonny Dykes. He was a little, when we were talking to him, I think a little wistful about, well, what if our defense had just been a little better? What if our offensive line had been a little tougher up front? I think he knows he had a chance to have a really special group. That's another completion for Goff along the sideline, out of bounds, short of the first down. That's Chad Hansen, who's made a few catches in this game.
Very simple, what looks like a simple throw. The reality is he made a play fake. He loaded his arm. He threw it with accuracy 30 yards across the field to hit a guy behind the line of scrimmage that makes 6 yards. And that's the beauty of Jared Goff, the simplicity in his release.
Second down and 5.
And this is tempo that Cal is not used to.
Not at all
for right now.
Muhammad close to the first down. We'll see where they spot him.
And this might be in response as much to the fact that they have a lead, but also how easily Air Force has moved the ball against them. Sonny Dykes may be saying, hey, guys, let's shorten this game. We need to take time off the clock. We're in the lead, but they've scored very easily, both throwing the ball and running the ball against our defense. Let's let the offense take time off the clock. Let's do the survey says thing and get in the best play.
Short by about a half a yard. It's 3rd and 1. With Watson as the tailback. They'll give it to Trey Watson to the left side with a pretty good push up front. First down, Cal.
I think the real question in my mind, and maybe your mind, Dave, is Sonny thinking about that touchdown record, and do we want to deviate just a little bit to get Goff another touchdown pass in this game? Because that would go against the school of thought of what they're doing, but I wouldn't be that surprised.
Well, maybe you can accomplish both. Wind the clock down and then give Goff another final couple chances in what could well be the last 6 minutes of his Cal career. Watson with the first down run, nowhere to go. Stop for no gain. Timeout. Air Force, I mean, really, in some ways, doesn't matter when you use them. Stop the clock, save that time. So Air Force burns one. We'll take a timeout ourselves. Cal leading 52-36.
It's what's made him so good and what makes him so dangerous.
452 yards, second most touchdowns thrown at any bowl game in college football history. And who knows, maybe another one still to come. With under 6 to go, out of the timeout, Watson. No, a flag. There was a big hole, but the play is not going to count. They blow the play dead.
Before the snap, false start. Offense number 4, 5-yard penalty, remains second down.
That's a cardinal sin for a wide receiver on a running play that goes away from you to try to jump the snap count. And that's unfortunate, especially when you're in a situation late in the game when you're trying to protect the lead and run the clock. And you see just, yeah, that little, he tried to get a little start. Gotta just watch the football from there.
Second and 15 now for Cal.
Notice I said cardinal sin. I thought you might jump on that.
The Cal folks would be very upset. Goff will throw back to his left and complete the pass out into the open with a nice burst of speed. Trevor Davis got stopped close, but again, depending on the spot, I think, well, no, they're going to say first down. He got there.
Nice job. Nice execution. A sprint out, throwback, screen. Somewhat dangerous. One of the D linemen almost read that and tried to pick it off. He couldn't quite get there.
Well, the comeback win against Arizona State, which was impressive, and Jared said maybe the most memorable game of his Cal career, and now this one against Air Force. That's 2 games.
Yeah, that's not a bad 2-game stretch.
Over 1,000 yards, 11 touchdown passes. So if this is it for him, quite a finish to his Cal career. Muhammad cuts. Now a flag thrown. So I think that one's going to be against the Bears for a holding call.
Usually in holding the
holding. Offense number 73, 10-yard penalty. First down.
And part of those skill set qualities that you were talking about, Mike, is what will be evaluated now as the draft process gets going after these bowl games. Todd McShay, we asked Todd for his list of strengths and needs. What do you think of that list?
Well, I would agree. I think balance, we talk about his control at the line of scrimmage. He's got great feet to keep moving. He's not as big and as strong as he needs to be. His consistency on some of the deep passes, we saw him overlead a couple guys today, but I agree with the comparisons. He's in an offense that throws the ball. You're going to be very comfortable, very accurate with a quick release, and those guys that we just named have that, those attributes.
First and 20, under 5 minutes to go now. Air Force still has one timeout. Hand the ball off and wary. A gain of a couple, and now Troy Calhoun will use that final timeout. Just hanging on to some last hope of a miracle come from behind win for Air Force. Timeout on the field. We'll be back after this, 52-36. Back here in Fort Worth, the Lockheed Martin Armed Forces Bowl, celebrating college football, celebrating our Armed Forces men and women, and a bowl game with armored vehicles and tanks in the parking lot. So they've done a great job.
Wasn't that how we got here today? That was our escort.
Now, see, that the next time we're here, we need to make that happen. And we do appreciate all of our service men and women across the world. Part of the theme of this game is showing our appreciation. Jared Goff in the shotgun. They're going to pitch. Trevor Davis with Goff throwing a block. In fact, throwing two blocks. Davis will be pushed out of bounds at the 19-yard line. So his Cal career may be coming to an end, but Jared Goff is still sticking his nose in there.
And Coach Dyke's going to use him any way he can. He ran the quarterback power today. Now he becomes the lead blocker on the reverse and actually gets a piece of a guy twice. That's pretty good. But now getting back down to business, is it time to throw the ball? Come on. Third and short.
If there was a sliver of doubt, hey, my coach is using me as a blocker here, maybe I should go to the NFL draft. Yeah.
That might persuade him that way.
One touchdown. He ties the all-time bowl record. They will hand the ball off. Watson, close. This could determine whether they have a chance to tie. They didn't get there. It's fourth down. I cannot imagine that Cal would go for it.
Good question.
Well, one official said fourth down, stuck the fist up and said no, and then the head referee came in and said first down.
Okay.
So I think the Air Force sideline is wondering what just happened there. What happened is Cal gets the first down. And on first down, they'll give it to Watson again.
Basically, Air Force is daring Cal to throw the ball. They're in the diamond formation, and they have a nine-man box coming after them. Receivers are one-on-one on the outside. So it'll be interesting to see. This is interesting dilemma for Coach Dykes in terms of running out the clock, running up the score, getting your quarterback maybe another record-setting touchdown pass.
We knew there'd be offense in this game. We've had better than 1,000 total yards, just over 1,000 total yards on both sides. Air Force has 418 yards of offense.
Yeah, normally 36 points and 418 yards of offense is a pretty good show. But today, Cal is one-upping them.
12th play of this drive, just what Cal wanted to try to shorten this game. It'll be third down. Well, maybe now. Third and long. One last shot to the end zone.
Well, I'll tell you what. Coach Dykes has done a great job today in this regard. That drive right there took a ton of time off the clock, and now he's made it. He's probably sealed the game in this regard, so I'm not sure what his mindset's going to be in terms of that potential tying touchdown pass.
It's been over 7 minutes that Cal's had the ball, so that's exactly what they wanted. Trying to end this game and get the bowl victory on third and nine. A handoff. So the record, I don't think, is important to Goff or Dykes or the Bears.
and they may not know about it, in all honesty. A lot of times coaches on the sideline don't think about those things, don't worry about those things. If somebody upstairs doesn't tell them, they're worried about what's the down and distance right now on this play, how do I win this football game, how do I protect my player?
And instead of kicking a field goal, could be on fourth down. Cal could take the clock all the way down, use their last timeout. They could also just hand the ball off once again. They're under a minute and a half to go.
One of the things sometimes, when you take a tempo team and you slow things down, they're not as effective. But I thought, really, the Cal offensive line is taking control of this game at this point when they've had to run the ball and people know they're going to run it. They've done a nice job.
They've played well. So that is the last timeout on either side. You can tune in to ESPN3. The postgame trophy ceremony presented by Capital One will commence immediately following the game. So Bears fans, it's been a while since they've watched a bowl trophy ceremony with their guys on the right side of things. 2009, the last time Cal won a bowl game.
And I'll tell you what, there's nothing like going to a bowl game, but there's nothing like winning a bowl game. Because if you don't win, you've got to live with that loss the rest of the year. Whereas when you win a bowl game, it buoys your recruiting. Your kids feel better in the winter workouts. It's a heck of a boost for a program.
Well, did Jared Goff just come off the field for the final time as a Cal quarterback? I think the answer is yes.
I would agree with you. I think that he's had a tremendous career, and he's going to take his talents elsewhere to the next level.
So they will kick a field goal with Matt Anderson. Kick is up and good. Well, Jared Goff, and I think everybody knows it on that Cal sideline. Six touchdowns. Let's see them all. Why not?
Yeah, let's take a look. Here's the first one over the top, right in the corner to Treggs. Really nice throw. This play action. Finds Powell over the middle. Going deep. Right in that window to his favorite receiver, Lawler. Found him again. Nice, easy throw there. And then a great throw under pressure. There's some duress. And then the screen, which was an unintended dividend in a sense. Easy throw, nice run.
Our Capital One player of the game. Not a lot of nuance to this decision. Pretty easy call. Jared Goff, 467 yards, 6 touchdowns, no interceptions. Tied for the second most in FBS bowl history, those touchdown passes, and you like the zero.
I love the zero. That's a great football game, but you throw it that much for that many yards and touchdowns. Sometimes interceptions are going to occur, tip balls, but he was flawless today.
Well, look, the announcement is not official, but you can tell with what's going on the sideline.
Well,
everybody
I don't
knows.
Know. Coach Dykes is recruiting him right now. Sure you don't want to do this again? How about another year? Come on now.
Next year we'll get you 7 in a game. He deserves to smile, a kid who came from a Cal family, who loved the program as a kid, came to a struggling program, and has them back in a bowl game, and they're going to win a bowl game up 55-36 with a record-type performance from him in his final game with the Bears. Air Force still has a minute and 11, and I think Air Force deserves credit for the way their season has gone. Look, we saw San Diego State against Cincinnati in a bowl game absolutely destroy Cincinnati. Air Force took San Diego State right down to the end of the Mountain West Conference championship game. Air Force has had a lot of injuries this year, and yet here they are, not only in a bowl game, 8-win team, nearly a conference championship. I think they have a lot to be proud of.
Troy Calhoun is a tremendous football coach and does a great job with the talent available to him. He beat a Boise team that gave up 33 yards to their opponent in the bowl season. So I agree with you. I think that Air Force is a tremendous team, does a great job, and is really a great competitive team.
How about this one down the field, incomplete, intended for the tight end, Garrett Griffin. Didn't get a lot of chances, is a good player.
Oh, that was a great throw by Carson Roberts. That was right on the money down the field. The one thing about Air Force, they're never going to give up. They're going to fight tooth and nail to the end.
Well, the football careers of many of these Falcons coming to an end today, but that does not mean their Air Force careers are coming to an end. Far from it.
No, they're going to go on active duty and serve our country and do a great job. And Coach Calhoun detailed some of the things that their typical day, and it's a little bit beyond what most college students think about.
Pitch it to the left side, Owens, who will get stopped at the 40-yard line, short of a first down, under a minute to go from Fort Worth.
They've used all their timeouts, so this is just a question of trying to continue to move the ball and maybe get a score, but continue to fight.
Third and two. Roberts to Robinette for an Air Force first down across midfield. Again, that trophy ceremony presented by Capital One follows on ESPN3. When we're done here, we'll get you to the Russell Athletic Bowl, North Carolina Baylor. Roberts being pressured. Roberts will be sacked. And that could be it. Cal thinks it is. They're ready to celebrate. And I think Air Force is just going to let the time wind off the clock. If that's it, what a finish for Jared Goff as Cal beats Air Force by the final score of 55-36. So the Bears with their eighth win of the year. That wraps it up for all of us here in Fort Worth. Now off to the Russell Athletic Bowl. North Carolina Baylor next.